If I had my power.
What was that?
Already?
Yeah.
Feel right, special.
Pretend we're happy.
I'm caring.
Do we get paid for these appearances, Susan?
Yes, of course. The check is in the mail.
Has Brian with a Y showed up yet?
Yep, he showed up.
Okay.
Brian with a Y.
And he says he's on Instagram. Oh. I said, great, I'll send you a picture of my food. That's all there I can communicate with you. Okay, here goes. Karen, are you here? Hi, Karen. Go to your room for, they're just picking names.
Wow, she just got here and she's already in trouble.
Wait, so we're missing.
Go to your room.
Go to your room.
What is Karen's last name?
Arroyo. No. It depends on how you pronounce it, depending on which, if you pronounce it in Spanish or you pronounce it in Portuguese, or you try to do it with some kind of New England. Aranjo, Arroyo, A-R-O-Y-J-O.
I think we can just wait for Karen to come back and ask her.
I'll get a story. Here comes Deborah. Where did she go?
Yeah, where is she?
She's disappeared.
She probably hit the wrong button.
Leave meeting. Oh, there she is.
So she's on.
She was in your room, so I see what she did. She left.
Well, it's taking other people a longer time. We win this round.
Yeah, can we start earning points now?
20 points.
Yeah.
Sure.
Here we go. I'm trying to figure out where I'm going to put the next person who walks in. Mono showed up. Brian showed up. Newman showed up. While you guys were gone. Well, say something intelligent. You're being recorded, so. Hi, listeners. Something
intelligent.
We've just come back from a break. Kelly, you think you're going to be here for a while or not for a while?
I mean, I'm feeling okay now. I don't want to jinx it, but I think I'll be on for a while.
Okay, so I'm going to give you co-host powers because you know how much that annoys
I'm just...
You've got the power.
Pretty hard, so I'm like bracing myself for some bad side effects, but hopefully that at least...
Well, so bad would be... low-grade fever for a couple of days and aches and pains and chills, right?
Yeah, I've heard some people who were pretty miserable for 2-3 days, so.
Did you get the Moderna? Mm-hmm. Did you just get it today?
The second one.
Yeah.
I've heard a lot of just like lethargy too. People just get really worn out.
Oh, and taking 12 to 14 hour naps. I heard that too.
That's why I wanted to make sure I got it before I had to go back to work on Monday. So I have all weekend to just chill and do what I can.
I think what's going on is people are thinking they might get not feel good. So they get all the junk food they possibly can and they get it all ready and they figure out what they're going to watch on Netflix. And they're like, okay, I'm ready. And so, you know, if you feel like crap, even a little bit, you're going to be like, all right, got to eat all this junk food. Yep. Junk food ain't going to eat itself.
I have a burrito bowl in the refrigerator waiting for me and fried rice.
Somebody's got it all figured out.
But if you sleep for 12 to 14 hours.
So this is the game I was talking about.
Oh, say it. Sagrada?
Sagrada.
Sagrada.
Yeah.
And it's a two-person game?
It's a what? You can play it two-player. It works two-player. And what I love about it is like every part about it is very pretty. Like they spent a lot of time making everything really, like really stand out. And like, this is just a box for rolling the dice in because the game is fundamentally about doing a lot of dice rolling with these cool colored plastic die.
Is it that?
Like they're all clear colors.
Oh,
and you put them, and the idea is that you're trying to arrange them in certain patterns on one of these boards, and you make a little stained glass window here at the bottom out of dice.
That's cool. Very cool. Oh,
spell the name favorite. Again?
Sagrada. It's in the chat.
Mm-hmm. It means sacred in Spanish.
It's really fun.
That is nice.
It's named after the Sagrada Familia, which is the which is a famous stained glass maker in Italy.
Oh, that does sound familiar.
I like Italian paper. I use it in origami. It's just beautiful, wonderful colors and patterns and things.
Italian paper, but you don't, I don't even know what that is, but you don't know what Italian ices are. I'm shocked.
He's Australian. Give him a break. Better than
other Thanks paper. A lot. Let me show you.
Yeah, the Sagrada Familia is that, is the, mm-hmm. the cathedral in Barcelona.
No, it's good because it's something else familiar.
Yeah, that's a different one.
Oh, look at Carl put in here. Cool Azul Rule yeah. School.
No, it's
at the zoo.
Yeah, we were there, Robin, and unfortunately it was closed for renovation, so we only got to see the outside.
Huh. Where's it at?
But it's called Sagrada Familia in Barcelona.
Oh, Barcelona.
Oh.
It's called
Barcelona.
The Gaudi. It's Gaudi, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
God, that place is... Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
so is it the same
name? Impressive.
Yeah, Sagrada Familia, Sacred Family.
Remember the first name.
So that's just an example of the Rossi handmade Italian paper.
Ah.
And when you fold that, the origami is just sensational.
Oh my gosh. Mm. I would wear that.
Oh, it is very pretty.
Gorgeous.
It's a nice
tattoo. Ain't no tattoo?
Yeah.
Yeah, Sunder's going to just have that tattoo
his arm,
on his body.
His sleeve.
This?
Yeah.
Oh, look, there's Caspian. Hello, Caspian. Where's Jamie?
She's on another call.
Okay, but she's there.
Yes, she's still here.
Okay, still here. Still
playing trivia with somebody else.
She's in another call.
Caspian?
What?
When are you coming over?
When am I what?
When are you coming over to play this game?
I do not know.
You said you'd ask. That was days ago.
That was yesterday.
That was days ago.
COVID time.
Pandemic times. It's the
pandemic time.
That was less than 24 hours ago. That wasn't even a
in
day.
In your world, in my world, that was 2 days ago.
You've got a weird time warp going on.
Well,
we all do.
Let's do time warp.
Is there such thing as a normal time warp or an un?
Remember, well, time seems to pass faster as you get older.
All right, so let's go with our game. So we've got a few new people here that weren't here a little bit ago. So say hello to Mono and Karen and Brian and Newman. Who else joined that you guys didn't see? I think that's it. So that's welcome, you guys. All right, group number one, who will only be group one, number one for a little bit. Avi, Ben, Brian, Carrie, Deborah, and Kelly. Who are you guys tonight? Don't Deborah. Brush me. Is that the name of the group?
Kelly, who's scorekeeper? Who wrote it down? Oh, Deborah wrote it down.
Okay, I'm going to type it in the chat.
Oh, she's afraid to say it. Oh, God, what is it going to
be? The rest of us can't remember. It was so long.
A six-fold decrease in chicken for breakfast.
There you go.
Doesn't that, yeah.
People are going to go, what the hell?
What? Damn, that's the other name. Damn.
The odds must be crazy.
Oh my gosh. Where's Wendy when we need her?
That's a good question.
Sixfold. She isn't feeling good, so poor thing.
When do we ever not need Wendy?
Well, We always need Wendy.
We always need
I know.
Wendy.
She isn't feeling great. Hopefully Wendy. Next week. Sixfold decrease in chicken for breakfast.
For breakfast.
They stole our name.
Oh, I'm thinking of a new name for next week now.
Okay, team number two. Who is the only number two for the moment? Faith and Romero, Julie and Jeff. Lou, Saunders, Newman, and Brian.
We're the non-essential oils.
The non-essential oils. That's good. I can say that. Very good. Oh, I was going to put this on your room. So.
Are those sold by non-MLMs?
That's it.
Yeah, yes. You buy them from all of the non-homeopathic places.
They're sold by single level marketing.
Single SLM. Good, that's a good one.
That is very good. Okay.
Nice time, Robert.
Okay, so now we have room number three, team number three, Carl, Leonard, Mike, Robin and Karen. Who are you guys tonight?
We are inspired by Leonard's photography. We are this way to the great egress of no regrets or frets for snowy egrets.
Oh God.
That ain't gonna fit. That's a mouthful. Name, so.
That actually developed in real time on a Facebook chat under Leonard's photo of the egret.
Yeah, this way to the great egress of no regrets or frets for snowy egrets.
Very wow. Good. Wow.
Nice.
Nice.
Do you see seashell on the t-shirt too?
Damn, we should have went with muons.
Okay, group number four. So that'd be Kevin, April, Aaron, James, Jane, and Mono.
Okay.
Oh my God, that's cruel.
Oh, Worcestershire. Nice. Worcestershire.
Worcestershire versus
Worcestershire.
Worcestershire. Oh,
Worcestershire.
Worcestershire. It's Worcestershire.
Oh, that's cruel.
Washington versus Worcestershire.
That's a classic.
Ooh, they shortened out with negative points in group number four already, I see. Okay, number five, Gail, Jamie, Caspian, Janine, Peggy, and Sarah.
It was foretold that we would win.
Ooh.
Ooh. Happy there.
It was foretold that we would win. That's good.
From what we've learned about psychics, that means you've got like a 10% chance.
Add that to the predictions, Richard.
There is a chance.
Well, if there's five groups, isn't it a 25% chance or 20% chance?
No, the talent is distributed evenly. And also the knowledge of the categories to come is distributed evenly.
Yeah, because we don't know. Just
and like, that you don't get bad luck by making a wild guess.
I've just shown my lack of statistical knowledge.
Oh, I'm just going off the psychic's track record, assuming the foretelling.
True.
Foretelling of foretelling. Right. All right. So Deborah, there she is. I have to find her. Everybody gets all like congealed on the screen. All right.
Whatever she meant by that.
Yeah. Okay. So I was going to do this. Copy. And get these.
Are you recording this time?
Yep. It's saying it, isn't it? Yeah, okay. It's
there. It says in the upper left corner.
Yeah,
we're recording. So,
I see it now.
Alrighty, potatoes. So we've got.
Alrighty, potatoes?
Yeah.
Why not?
You got a problem with that?
They go well with chicken.
All right, Deborah,
Richard may not get the reference to Orida potatoes. Because Orida is a brand around here.
Yeah, I thought it was a strange expression. Okay.
So I've given you powers, Deborah, and Kelly has got the other powers.
Richard, it's Oregon, Idaho.
Oregon, Idaho.
All right. Okay.
Okay, looks like people are muted, maybe? No, not yet. Some people.
We'll do it after. We want to do it after we hear your category.
Okay, so the category is occupations and activities.
Ooh.
All right, 3, 2, 1. Deborah, you'll have to unmute yourself.
Good call. I'm expecting high scores, hopefully. This will be not too hard. So the, like I said, the category is occupations and activities. And the first question is this. The words goofy, switch, and regular all refer to one specific thing in at least four activities. Three of these activities have the same one word as part of their name. What is that word? And I'm going to put that in the chat. Okay. All right. And then the second question. Most of the rest of these are going to be lists of words that they each relate to a specific activity or occupation. And your job is to figure out how the words are related and come up with the name of that activity or occupation. So the first list for question number two are these words: arete, barn door, chimney, dino, flash, pitch. And I'll put those also. I can get them to copy. There we go.
Can you put somewhere those that instructions, these questions?
Oh, okay, yeah, I'll put that at the top of this one. Okay. Oops. Nope. No. Wrong key. Okay. Hopefully that'll all fit. Let's see.
You can always break it up.
Yeah, no, it fit. Okay. Okay.
I don't see it.
You don't? Oh, wait, maybe I didn't hit enter. Hang on. Wait. Hang on. There. Okay. So there's the instructions for most of the rest of these and the first one of the lists. Okay. Uh-oh, shoot. Let's see here. Ah. Oh. Shoot, I lost one of my lists. Hang on. Okay. Right back.
Hang in there, Kelly.
I'm good, just a little sleepy.
Kelly, how was your drive back?
Very long.
How many drivers?
Me and my mom. It was uneventful. We didn't hit any traffic or anything until actually my mom hit traffic between here and her house. So a 3-hour drive was 4.5 for her. But I didn't hit any traffic while I was in the car, so I'm fine.
Did you spend one night on the road or what?
Yeah, we did most of the driving yesterday and then a little bit this morning, and then I went and got my shot. It was great.
Okay, I temporarily lost the next list, so I'm going to have to kind of wing it here. The next set of words is flail, nodule, shock, lodging, disc, and grange. So let me see if I can put these in the chat here. It might take me a minute to do this. This copy pasting thing. This one. Next one. There. Okay. Close that. All right.
Bless you, Susan.
Okay. The next list, which is question four, is surcingle, martingale, egg butt, Kimberwick, Capriole, and Passage. Okay. Let's see here. Okay, the next one, question five. Based, bias, notch, drape, feed dogs, notions. Okay. And number six, trolling, weedless spoon, beadhead, dapping, mending, wind knot. And number seven, bait, brancher, ayahs, feek, imping, lawn carp, mantle, stoop. Okay. And number eight, adds, gimlets, fro, spoke shave, spindle molder, mortiser. Okay, and number nine is backline, bridge, middle eight, gain, capriccio, grody, lick, scat, gizmo. Okay, and then for number 10, I picked out just a few of those words, and because we can only have one answer now, we can't have multiple answers. Define any one of these words within the context of their question above, and for bragging rights, define all five of them. So here are the ones. Okay, those are your questions. Good luck.
Gee, those are easy, Deborah.
For some people.
Super high score.
I was excited when I knew number one, and then I was disappointed by the other nine.
It's always terrifying when people say they expect high scores.
Robin, well, all of them are easy if you know them.
I swear I'm going to write a paper on this. Lighthouses, okay. And whatever the hell this is.
So hopefully these are broad enough that there'll be somebody in each group that has some knowledge of some of them and you can work the rest of it out. But I don't know that I expect tens, but
just don't hold your breath.
Eight to nines, people.
I was just thinking that everybody else was just keeping quiet because they knew all this stuff and I'm just should keep my mouth shut because I'm
eight or nine in difficulty. Yes, I agree, at least.
Oh Lord. Okay. Right.
Well, it can't be worse than some of them, like Punch and Judy.
Oh, don't make it a Chelsea, Deborah. We shall see.
Looking too cocky.
Okay, so are we ready to go to our rooms?
We could just say we didn't and just say nobody got any points.
There you go, Carl.
Not going to be very different.
If we Deborah says we should know these, we should know
our room. Be very different.
All right. Sounds like some people know some of them, so.
Okay, yep. Good luck.
Oh, the name got cut off.
Okay, Deborah, you got your powers. You should be able to breeze around the rooms.
Should I go visit?
You can go visit anywhere you want, or I can fling you from.
I think I can visit. Is Gail just staying here with us?
No, Gail.
My thing is frozen. I hit join, and it's just going around in circles.
It says not join. Okay, so you should be all right. It says you're in the right room.
It's not. I'm not going there though.
You might want to exit and then come back in. If it doesn't go in a minute or two, I don't know what's going on with your connection, but it's says you're in the room. I mean, it says it's just waiting for you to join.
And it says on here, not responding.
Okay.
That's a computer.
It's a computer thing. So you hang out and talk to Deborah for a minute or two.
Okay. So I see the breakout room button,
mm-hmm.
but it's just giving me a list of the people and I can move them and do all this other
stuff. On the right-hand side, it should say join.
Maybe it's not big enough. I don't know. It says move to.
Yeah.
I don't see a join thing. I don't want to move people.
No, you should be able to on the very right-hand side.
Oh, you got to roll over it. I see. Okay.
Right. Never mind. So Gail's still telling you to.
I'll go visit.
Gail's frozen. There she is. Back. Okay, now let me try. Gail goes into room 5. Okay, that's better. Now let me try putting you in 5.
Okay. It kicked me out altogether, so it must be my
It must have been, yeah. Okay, so now what does it do? Okay.
Deborah,
hello, gang.
We're being recorded. Hello.
Deborah, how specific do we need to be?
I'm generous. These are all going to be very broad.
Okay.
Well,
that's helpful.
All of these terms except for scat almost relate to guitar, not scat. And I don't know what roadie means. But we could just say like music as an activity. Right. Musician.
Right.
Musician.
Okay. You guys know some of these?
Two of them.
We've got two.
Kind of.
Which one?
We've got another one is roofer.
I think number 2 is roofer.
But... So we both.
Oh, let's look at that one.
So okay, wait, so what do you guys got?
Wait, how many musicians are in this room?
I'm here. It's just us.
Okay, so there's 4 musicians in this room?
Oh,
5 musicians. Great. So we're still confused.
What does Grody mean? Anybody know what Grody means? I would guess it's something, some like play on roadie. Because I
would say we have enough confidence that this should all be related to musician.
Okay.
Which ones have you guys got? I don't know.
1 and 9. Two.
1 and 9. I think 2 is roofer because of.
I mean, there's definitely a lot that have to do with that.
Chimney flash.
I'm not sure about
flash and pitch. I don't know about dino.
Dino roof? I don't know. And I don't know what.
But barn door.
Barn door's pushing it, but.
I thought it was whenever you leave your fly unzipped.
For 2, I was thinking maybe just builder.
Yeah.
Okay, construction. Go as broad as possible.
Pitch, that makes sense.
Right.
Wait a minute, we're back to music. Pitch, flashy.
No.
Yeah.
I don't know though, chimney, it still seems to be more related to roofing than general construction though.
But she said very broad, so we should just do
how construction. Broad, okay.
Right.
For number 2, I don't know why I'm thinking of like.
That was number 2.
Yeah.
No, sorry, number 3.
Okay.
The one without a number. I'm like.
Don't confuse me anymore.
Of things like for horses and stuff like.
Because
like Grange is like of some agricultural thing. I could see I think flail was used when you're like for like hitting horses and stuff if you're evil. You can like, I can see like a nodules, like something there. Like these all seem like they could be related to farming or.
Right.
Yes, Susan.
Deborah is a huge horse person.
Ah.
Horses.
So
know your audience.
So I would not be shocked at all if she had a whole bunch of things that were kind of horse related.
Horsey.
Kelly, are you getting the chills?
No, I just realized my roommate put mascara on me today to take a headshot and I forgot and wiped my eye. So now I just look like I'm
dying. She put mascara on you. You were there and knew that, right?
I don't wear makeup usually, so it's on, I forget that it's on.
Okay. Just like, actually,
I guess I put the mascara on myself now that I think about it, but it was at her instruction.
Just do a bunch more and then you'll match your background.
True. This is perfect for Hello. There we go.
Yeah. There you go. Perfect.
Okay, just keep it in.
Deborah says the categories are general categories.
General categories. Okay.
Whatever. So did you need a headshot because you'll be scatting later or?
No.
She got her shot.
I'm going to be working with a podcast and they asked me for a headshot.
Really?
I'm going to be helping them do background research.
Is anybody going to tell Susan?
Yes. I was planning on telling Susan when they put the headshot. I assume they're putting the headshot up on the website. So I was going to tell everybody then when I could show them on the website, but.
Well, we're being recorded, so you might as well.
Tell them.
Okay, so we're going back to this.
Are we still thinking horse for the third one then?
Yeah, I guess.
Horses.
Can you shock a horse? I hope that doesn't mean what I think it means.
Poor horse.
I mean, that's almost as bad as flailing your horse.
So number
How about, what are four? They?
Well, yeah, let's keep going and we can come
let's
back.
Let's go, yeah. I'm not, I don't know on four. That's some interesting names there.
Does it's it just something
birds.
You're thinking of.
Yeah. What was that?
Birds. There has to be a bird named the egg butt.
Maybe it's birding.
Bird. Yeah.
Egg butt, passage, martingale.
Birding.
They sound like.
Yeah, birds. That makes sense. I like that.
I think number five is a seamstress. But
sewing, something to a sewing.
Yeah, I was definitely going to say five is got to be something sewing or dressmaking, something, you know. But it's going to be general, so probably just sewing.
Sewing will do.
Six would be
How about fishing for six? Trolling.
Yeah, trolling.
They all sound like, what do you call it, lures. Beadhead, wind knot, something fishing.
Trapping, mending. But then you have mending, that's kind of similar to
the sewing one.
Yeah, the sewing one.
That's
so
obvious. Because that would be
what is a weedless spoon?
Would it be sailing?
That'd be a spoon without weeds.
We could ask sailing? People in New York, they just legalized
weed. There's no way this is if this is sailing, then there's
it's
something wrong.
Okay.
Let's go fishing.
Let's go fishing. Hope we got that one.
It's just a guess because the beadhead, windless spoon, and I don't know.
It's good enough guess for me.
All right, we're all in a hurry to get out of this one, it sounds
sure.
Like.
Anytime I hear this is going to be easy. There's going to be high scores. It's like.
But number seven, then it's people that did not win Best Actress. Last names of people that did not win Best Actress.
There you go.
Lawn carp. Is that one word?
She
or
lost.
Is that two?
I remember that distinctly. She lost in 1952.
I would make a safe bet that a lawn carp did not win Best Actress.
There you go.
Well, that's what he said. There are people who did
I
not.
Mean, we could probably give that answer for most of these.
We can also say these are all objects not in our house right now.
There you
not
go.
In the room with me. They are not.
You find out that one of them's in your house and you never even knew it.
Abigail Lawncarp was very distressed when she lost. It was a big story, I remember.
They could be rappers. Could they be rappers? Lawncarp.
Oh yeah, okay, let's go with rap music. That's
there you go.
Oh come on.
I don't
Brancher. That one sounds familiar. I'm trying to remember what like a Brancher is.
Freak?
What's a feek?
No idea.
Sounds nasty.
Imping?
Wait, does this spell
I don't think that's not a nice thing to say.
E-F-I-B-B-E-F-I-L-M.
Backline no. Bridge? Is it... See, there's no spaces in between. There are no dashes are in between these, so I'm looking at it on a different thing than you guys are. So I'm not
sure. Oh yeah, it's
ran together or
nice and separate.
They're all separate except for lawn carp.
Lawn carp.
No clue.
Yeah, let's go on and come back if we're struck with
inspiration. Gimlets, fro, spindle, mortiser.
And spoke shave.
So adds is...
Ah, spoke shave.
That's that. Good.
So adds is a woodworking tool, right?
Okay.
And it's I know what it is, but I
can't. Yeah, well, and then I was looking at mortiser thinking, you know, it's someone who's like working with brick or, you know, so would that be some sort of like construction?
We already have construction for something though.
Yeah, well, we had like roofing or, but.
More construction?
More construction. Maybe more construction part two.
Electric boogaloo. Oh God, let me think.
What is
I originally read that as spindle monster.
Well, what's mold? I know what monster means, but what does molder mean? Any idea?
Well, like you're molding something, but
wasn't he the X-Files guy?
Maybe it's bartender. Maybe these are some kind of crazy drink thing.
Well, gimlets is, well, it's gimlet, not with an S, but
just saying. I'm pulling stuff.
Yeah, but if you just give a random list of words, they probably somebody has come up with drinks.
Yeah, with a drink named that, I would agree.
Great.
If there wasn't for more, I mean, fantastic. I don't know, we could say woodworking, but I don't think you or I don't think mortiser would fit for woodworking.
What is a middle eight?
That's a
where's middle eight?
That's on the next one.
That's nine. That's the one that we're pretty sure it's music related.
Find something.
No, we got musicians.
Yeah, musician for that one.
Oh, for middle eight, the number nine?
Number nine.
Middle eight is going to be the same as bridge.
Gimlets. Gimlets. Isn't that something to do with sewing? Gimlets? On the clothing?
You did sewing.
We got sewing for a different one.
But isn't a gimlet something you put on your, like a buttonhole thing? Gimlet? No.
An eyelet?
Oh, that's an eyelet. Yeah, well.
Wait, so this one's
similar? They're similar.
I still want to look up these words.
Spokes? Hey, spokes and spindles.
Maybe this is a wheel maker. Who makes wagon wheels?
Hey, is it spindle Wagoner? Molder or just spindle and then molder?
Spindle molder.
Yeah, it's one more one line.
Okay.
One term.
Deborah's smiling.
I haven't molded a good spindle in so long.
I know. God, I can't wait. I'm going to get a pedicure and get my spindle molded.
Yeah, exactly.
I want to ask what that means.
I can't wait to order a fro gimlet. That's what I'm going to do.
Oh, I know. Have you had a fro gimlet?
We could try to do 10, but I think...
Well, let's get... Well, okay. So this is easy then, but bridge has multiple meanings. So bridge is either the middle of a song or it's on a violin, a bass, a guitar.
A lick?
It's music.
Oh, guitar. It's a guitar lick.
But yeah, bridge is not one of the choices for 10.
So many instruments have bridges, plus it's part of a song.
But that's...
So we're define any one of these words.
Well, but it's any one of the below, and bridge is not in the list.
Okay, so middle eight's the same thing as a bridge.
Is it?
Yeah, in the 32 bar form, it's 16, 8, and 8. So the middle eight's the middle of the tune.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, I thought you were talking about bridge, like the physical bridge that is the part of the instrument. And I was like, that doesn't sound right. That is what I was thinking as well.
So which one are we missing?
Well, it has double meaning. If you're a jazz musician and you say go to the bridge, it means the little eight bars in the middle of the tune.
The eight bars that are the difference that are different than the first two sections of the last one.
The AABA.
I was when you said it was the same thing as the bridge, I was thinking the bridge of the instrument itself.
I was thinking the bridge of the Starship Enterprise.
There you go. I like that.
Or Scientology. Maybe. You're going on the bridge, Scientology bridge.
Yeah. Of course, middle eight, I mean, you know.
You leave my thetans alone.
which ones are we missing so far, you guys?
1 through 10.
Which ones did we skip? We said we'd go back to
7 and 8 and 10, unless you want to just take middle eight, but
that's fine,
I like that definition.
Yeah, I do too.
Brancher.
So I just wrote the middle eight bars in a 12 bar form.
Freak feet.
32.
Wait, what?
32 bars. No, sorry. Not 32
bar. We don't have to get that specific. We don't have to get that specific. How many bars? It just.
Okay.
Could it be parts of a house? On seven, you've got a stoop. You've got a mantle. A lawn carp might be something to do with the house.
Wait. You're right, though. The middle eight thing has no relate. If those are supposed to be related to everything that's the same, then I have no idea.
No, it's
no, not those. They're not related to that. Each one of those relates.
That's what I was thinking. But somebody, I just got messed up in my.
No, I think she's asking for a definition, right, of those words as they pertain within to the other.
Well, what's the name other?
The number 10 ones are not related.
Right.
She's asking for the definition as related to the question that it's in.
Yeah, those are separate. Each one.
Okay.
So where are we?
Could they be made of stone?
Where are we?
I was looking at seven.
Seven?
Because you could have a stoop is like a porch. You walk up a stoop, right?
Right.
And then a mantle is which you would put your Christmas ornaments or your Christmas stocking from on your chimney, right?
Yeah.
Mantle piece.
But that could also be wood.
Could be a fish on your lawn.
You know, one of those metal things that sticks up, right?
Those go very well with the flamingos.
and a feek, you know, I don't want to brag and guess these by myself. I'm going to have to let you guys have a turn.
Maybe this is chimney sweep.
Oh, wait, lawn carp. Maybe they're those little statues that when you go through Maine and you see those people that have like the butterflies on their houses and the crystal balls on the front lawn.
I've never been through Maine. Otherwise, I would know exactly what you're talking about.
Maybe it's a chimney sweep.
Do they have baits? Like Norman Bates?
That's a weird word too, actually.
Bait?
Yeah,
house. Bait. The Bates house? Bait? Get it? House? Mantle house? Stoop house? Could they be?
Yeah, are they all related to a chimney? But chimney, wasn't chimney in one of the other categories?
How long has it been?
Forever and ever.
just give us a zero and let's end the misery.
Boy. Yeah, so when we go back, Susan, you can say, okay, category two, who's up?
You know what?
We'll just skip and not grade it.
I think we at least got two.
Okay, yes. Well, do something.
Maybe more, three, right? If we're lucky.
How about seven is put things you put, things that are put on a house.
Things
on a Halloween decorations.
A house.
How about this?
Oh, things you could put a Halloween decoration on: a stoop or a mantle. You could decorate for the holidays. You put your chimney
and a peak and a bake.
Imping implies like an action.
Yeah, and I always
like necessarily. Like the
toilet paper a house or something.
Like siding, it does you don't side a house, but you
right. Yeah, that's true. It's siding, but you side a house, but it's called siding. Yeah, I see that. Okay.
Well, that's nice you defined it then. That didn't help us.
So Kelly, you've been very quiet for the last 12 and a half minutes. Do you
I just don't know.
Yeah, I don't.
I can she just
have superpowers now that she's got her second shot. I don't.
Are
I don't
you sure you want to be power. Recording this?
Yeah.
I've never been more frustrated by words.
Well, not only that, not only do you have to figure out what they all relate to, but we don't know most of what these words mean.
Well, okay. Number eight, gimlets, right? We've all heard that. Gimlets, right?
I don't know why, but it's just making me think of like the little chiclets gum. That's all I've got.
Okay, so if somebody called you a gimlet, would you be upset?
I mean, a gimlet is a stone, isn't it?
Okay, there you go.
Sounds good.
But it's plural, gimlet.
So.
Well, and then you have mortiser. That's why I'm wondering if it's some kind of like stone making something.
It's all stone related.
A mason?
Yeah, mason. There you go. That's the word I was trying to think of.
Let's just put it. We don't have anything else.
Let's put it. I don't care.
Okay, so is there everything else?
Do we have something for seven?
What did we put for seven?
Seven was places you put Halloween decorations.
Yeah, I like that.
And that's a good occupation, isn't it?
I would be a professional Halloween
decorator.
Decorator, there you go.
Yeah, that's good.
Fortunately, we're just listening and so we'll be able to give our great answers. No one will know.
So what do we got?
A Halloween tree behind me.
Oh, are we? Is anyone actually taking the? Oh, hey!
Holy
God. It has. I took off the bells it had, but it has skeleton hands on it.
Cool.
Well, there you go. Just look, skeleton hands. Does it have a lawn carp?
It does not. It used to have a weeping angel on top, though, but that's been packed away till Halloween.
Ophrius or free.
Don't blink.
Beaks. I don't know. Okay, are we done? Put us out of the
I guess. Done. Did someone actually write this stuff down? I don't know if anyone else took notes.
I did, but.
Okay, thank you very much.
I have everything but 7.
Do we need to go back? Oh, yeah. What did we say? Was that the one that we said fishing is an option?
Scroll.
No. We are fishing.
That was for 6.
Fishing. 7, right. We said professional Halloween decorator.
Yes, there you go. Let's just do it. Professional say the heck with it.
Decorator.
All right. Good job, team.
Yay.
Uh-oh, where are we recorded?
Well, that was your weird. Best behavior now.
I thought we had time left and it just bounced us here.
Yeah. We had like 35 seconds left.
That's what I thought.
I thought we had a little bit more time. I wanted to say one thing to my people. I would like to change our guest on 3.
Where's Susan?
I support your decision, Robin.
Susan, what happened? We actually were looking...
willing to go along with what I wrote down. On
Susan, we were looking at
whatever,
the clock.
Whatever Robin wrote down is good.
We were looking at the clock, and it was down to about 30 seconds, and then bang, we were here. So I never saw that happen before.
I don't know.
Time flies when you're having fun.
We were talking amongst ourselves.
Well, in which case, it should be moving really slowly right now.
Hi, Susan.
Same thing for us too. It was weird.
I can't. I don't know. I actually enjoyed this category despite everything.
There she is. Hi, Susan.
Oh, Avi.
Yeah, but you're a mathematician, and they're weird.
It was horrible.
We had fun.
Susan, you're going to be happy you weren't here.
Okay. Good.
Number 1. Just letting you know.
Okay.
Hi, Susan. I was just going to tell you I would look for the link, but. I don't even know where I find the link.
Yeah, I had it. I think Susan was washing her hands or something. So,
oh, okay.
I was in my
No. Susan washes her hands. She doesn't wash her hands.
Wash. All right, Deborah. That was interesting.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Wait. Can we have a second? Robin was saying something and she was cut off. So did you say you came up with something?
I had another answer for 3, and several people on our team said they were willing to go with my answer. I wanted.
Okay, go ahead. Whatever it is.
Okay.
It's all on you, Robin.
So, Robin, why don't you send that to Rob in a private chat?
Oh, I'm okay. I have no idea. Whatever you say. We had nothing there, essentially. So.
Yeah, but that way
Susan.
Yeah, but I'm not a scorekeeper.
We were given a list of words that are supposed to be associated to an activity or an occupation, and the words were gibberish. No.
They were imaginary words, and it was all drinking games.
Oh.
It was quite.
Yeah, so Robin sent it to Carl.
I did.
Okay,
go ahead.
Oh, no, I sent it to Rob. Sorry.
Okay, send it to Carl.
Okay. Carl.
My screen's got switched up here, but that's
Paul.
Read them over again, though, because I want to hear you pronounce these words.
Oh, okay. Hang on, let me go in the chat
for the video.
Okay. So you want me to read? Okay. All right. Hang on here. So the first one was the words goofy, switch, and regular. All refer to one specific thing, and each in at least 4 activities. 3 of these activities have the same word as part of their name. What is that word? So the word is bored. Anybody get that?
Yep, we did.
Cool. Okay, so it's surfing, wakeboarding, snowboarding, and skateboarding.
Goofy board.
And goofy is when you have your left foot forward.
Oh, on a board. Goofy footed.
And actually switch is doing it whatever the opposite way of that you normally do it. So even if you normally do it that way, if you switch, it's the other way. Okay. These other words, the first part of the list, the question number two, aret is an exterior corner. These are all about climbing.
Yes.
Rock climbing, anything like that. Hang on, let me get my definitions open here.
Barn door.
Count because you have to climb
up. Deborah,
right?
Yes.
Barn door is when you're up like this and you kind of swing off to one side.
Right.
As if you were hinged. I've done that.
Right.
You don't have to define them.
Well, if anybody
we could have gotten that one if my daughter was home, but she's out in the middle of Arizona.
That's what they are.
So,
I missed one and two. Can you say what those were again?
So the word for number one is board, as in surfboard, snowboard, skateboard, wakeboard.
Okay.
Okay. Trying to use two screens, which I don't usually do. There. Okay. And the second one was climbing. And so aret is an exterior corner, like exterior corner of a building even. Barn door is, like Lou said, when you swing away from the rock as a result of being unbalanced. Chimney is a vertical crack on a wall of rock that's wide enough to fit your body into, and you kind of climb up it like a chimney. Dyno is a climbing term. It's a slang term for a dynamic move from one climbing hold to another. So basically, I know my son climbs sometimes, and it's kind of like you jump from one spot to the next spot above you. Hopefully above you anyway. Flash is when a climber uses prior knowledge and beta, they call it that, to ascend a route cleanly from the start to the finish on a first attempt without falling, of course.
That's very flash.
Huh? It's a flash. Yeah.
It's flash.
It's flash. And pitch is a route, basically, that can be climbed using a length of one climbing rope. And of course, climbing ropes can be different lengths, but
50 meters.
Okay, number three is farming or anything like that. Flail is something, a wooden bar with a handle that you use to remove grain and seeds from stalks. A nodule is something that it grows on the ground that fixes bacteria. Shock is a pile of grain set up in a cone shape. Lodging to a farmer is when your crop falls over. And it can be hard to harvest that way. Disc is an implement that's pulled behind a tractor that chops up the ground. And a grange is like a grange hall, like a meeting room. All right, number four is anything to do with horses or equestrian.
Told you.
A surcingle is a thing that goes around the horse. A martingale is a device that controls the upper head movement of a horse. Egg butts and kimberwicks are bits that they use. Capriole is and passage both are moves. In fact, let me see if I can share my
Capriole is kind of like a prancing jump.
Right. I mean, it's kind of dramatic.
Lipizzaners do it.
Yeah, lipizzaners mainly do it. I mean, you can train other horses to do it, but basically lipizzans are built to do it. They're kind of
Robin is going to train her dogs to do it.
let me see if I can share this because it's kind of cool. It'll open there. There. Okay, let's see if this works. Oh shoot. Maybe not. All right, skip that. Okay, back over here. Where did my Zoom go? Five is sewing. Anything like that?
Ooh, we got that.
I figured it'd be people that knew that one. Six is fishing.
Is that what we put, team, on that one? Feels like we put fishing on everything.
These are, they're either like a weedless spoon and bead heads are kinds of bait or like a beadhead's a fly, and a weedless spoon I think is a spinner of some kind. Dapping, mending are things you do when you're fly fishing mostly. A wind knot, I bet you everybody's had this happen if they have long hair even. When you're doing a long strand of something kind of gets caught and it suddenly just tangles itself without, you know, any help. Seven is to do with birds or birding or anything like that. A falconry is fine. Like brancher is a young bird that hasn't started flying yet.
Does it count that you had the right answer and the wrong question?
They're all dead birds and you decorate your house with them. Does that count?
Yeah, we had them for Halloween decorations.
I think that counts. We'll put that down.
Dead birds, of course.
Some of these
we get a half point for that.
I put these sorts because I really like them so much. Feek is when a bird cleans its beak. Now, if you've ever been close to a little bird or even a chicken or something, and they wipe their beaks back and forth on things. Imping is a method to repair broken feathers. They use a feather from another bird and insert the if your bird's feathers if they get injured.
Do we really need the definition of every term? This is
no, I just want to give you the ones I really like.
You haven't skipped one yet.
Yes, I have.
Imping I heard actually this week because there was some rescued, I think it was a red-tailed hawk or something, where they did that. They actually found a donor set of feathers for this bird.
Yeah. They can use crow's feathers if they're the right part of the wing. All right, one more bird thing. Lawn carp, because I just love it. It's urbanized Canada geese, which frequent city parks and picnic areas and golf courses.
And leave stuff everywhere.
My living in Canada, I live in the part of Canada that is prime Canada goose area. And I'm just having to like navigate around. Like there, I think it was this morning where I was walking to my office. And literally there was a goose just in the middle of the road and all the cars were just stopped on either side of it waiting for it to go across the street.
And you know, it's always-
That would only happen in Canada.
National bird, right?
Everywhere else, they just run the damn thing over.
It's always
been happening around here lately with turkeys.
In Seaside, California, they do that as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've had Canada geese.
Called Canadian geese rather than Canada geese. And I think, where's their passports?
They shit in our driveway.
Yeah, when the geese show up, I say take off, eh? They don't.
Okay, number eight is anything to do with woodworking, carpentry, anything like that. These are all pretty much tools to do different kinds of things. Spoke shave is like to do wheel spokes. Okay, and number nine is music. Anything to do with music. I figured people would know what some of the people would know what this was. A grody is a combination of groupie and roadie.
What was number eight? I'm sorry, I missed the answer.
Oh, woodworking.
Okay.
You guys want to see any of those woodworking things? I've got them all in the show.
Okay, and number nine was music.
Yep, and then the definitions, I think we did Arete already. Passage, I think maybe Leonard said what that was. It's kind of like a trot, but it's suspended. So they trot, but they're like in the air kind of as they go along. It's really kind of dramatic. Dapping is using a short amount of line and a long rod to softly place a fly or any kind of bait actually on top of where the fish are. So you pull like the part of the line back to you through the little thingies.
Hi, Isabella.
And it helps you control if you don't want to throw it like way far away.
Mike was demonstrating dapping really well.
Who was?
Mike.
Mike, yeah, was he? Okay.
There you go.
Yeah, that's it. And middle eight, I think someone already said what that was, but it's a British term for the bridge of a song. So that's it.
All right, scores. So sixfold decrease in chicken for breakfast.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That's the team I was on. Yeah, all right. Go team.
Good job. Good job.
Very, very impressed. We
yeah, really high scores.
The non-essential oils.
Got 8.
Ooh.
Oh.
This way to the great egress of no regrets or frets for snowy egrets.
I count 8.
I thought our 5 was good. All right, Washington versus Worcestershire.
8-7.
87?
Wow.
Yes, yeah,
it was foretold that we would win.
I count 6.
All right, so I'm putting Susan.
6.
And I'm going to put Susan and Isabella on their teams now that I know who's got the lowest scores.
That was a good plan, Jamie and Caspian. So you get an extra person now.
It's the Isabella sweepstakes.
It's like tanking in baseball, so you get the first draft pick.
That's probably there's going to be some category about serial killers, so you'll get a 10.
I was I was taking graduation photos and they took forever.
I should have done them for you
for school.
I got it there in 15 minutes. Okay, good job, everybody. We just finished round one. Oh, Lord. Okay. So Brian's up next. Where's Brian? There you are. I will give you your little powers of your powers. And I'm going to take them away from you, Deborah. I hope you enjoyed them while you had them. She's all set.
That was fun.
Good scores, medium scores. It certainly wasn't a Punch and Judy.
So what were all the scores?
5, 8, 8, 7, 6. I'll show you whenever we get to the second round. Okay. Brian. There he is. He's on mute. He's talking to us.
You're muted, Brian.
Yeah, nope. I am. You're right. I was like going to make a joke about it too and unmute myself and then just didn't work. So the first week I was on, Susan mentioned that there hasn't been a Kansas trivia category.
Ooh.
And seeing as I learned all this in elementary school, you guys should get high scores on it. But tonight we're going Kansas.
Everybody says that. Oh my God, that just means we're going to fail.
You talking about the band?
I was just going to say that. We're talking the band, right? Because I think I do all right in that category. Cool.
All right, meeting everybody in 3, 2, 1. Brian, you'll have to unmute again.
I did, but I was going to do the joke, but then I already gave up the ghost on it. So, all right, so I'll just get right to it. Kansas isn't known for a lot of things, but everyone is familiar with our tornadoes. How many tornadoes can Kansans expect in an average year statewide? Guess the range. 51 to 100, 101 to 150, 151 to 200, 201 to 250.
Whichever of those it is, it sucks to live there. We've had one in New Jersey in the last 5 years, I think.
It sucks to live there and it has nothing to do with the tornadoes.
I might agree with that.
As in sucks because the tornadoes will pull you up in the, forget.
Very nicely done. Okay, question 2. Kansas has only produced one U.S. president, Dwight David Eisenhower. Where can you find Ike's presidential library?
In Kansas.
Very good, Avi.
Yes, I was going to ask how specific.
Yes, we get 1 point.
I want a city.
Okay.
Or town, since we don't really have cities here.
Okay. Can we say in the path of a tornado?
Only sometimes. All right, question 3. Kamala Harris was sworn in on January 20th, 2021, making her the first female vice president of the United States. But Vice President Harris is not the first VP of color. That honor went to this Kansan who served as VP from 1929 to 1933. Question four. In 1954, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled in favor of the plaintiff in a case brought by a Topeka family and argued by future Supreme Court Justice Thurgood Marshall. Name this landmark Supreme Court case.
Robin, if you miss this one, we're taking away your degree.
And your license.
Peggy's also an attorney, just saying.
No hints.
I think I know the answer.
All right, number five. This Kansan of note won an Oscar for her role in the 1939 blockbuster Gone with the Wind and got her star on the Walk of Fame in 1960. Who was she? Ironically, Wizard of Oz came out in 1939 and she wasn't in that. So if that's a clue, I guess, I don't know. All right. Question six. Kansas native Ann Dunham isn't exactly a household name, but one of her children is. Name her famous child. Question seven. In 1854, the Senate passed the Kansas-Nebraska Act, which repealed the Missouri Compromise. This allowed new states to enter the Union as free or slave based on the wishes of the majority in each state. How did Kansas enter the Union? Question eight. You might run into Cousin Eddie on your way to Cocker City, where you'll find what claims to be the world's largest what? Question nine. Smith County, Kansas doesn't seem very original. It is situated along the Nebraska border and boasts a population of around 3,600 residents. What else is interesting about this Kansas county? And this is a really unfair question, and I do apologize. All right, question 10. Because I ran out of facts about Kansas.
I've had okay. that happen.
All right, you ready? Question 10. Before there was My Favorite Murder, there was In Cold Blood. This 1966 Truman Capote nonfiction novel details a brutal killing in rural Kansas. Name one of the following: the town in which the murders happened, the family that was killed, or either of the men who were executed for the crime.
Isabella's got them all. She's writing them down right now.
Yep, she knows.
Not. I'm like, I'm looking at photos.
When Brian was a child in Kansas, his teacher said to him, "Brian, when you need a trivia category, you're going to be all set."
Yeah.
Brian, why do all the trees in Missouri slant eastward? Because Illinois sucks and Kansas blows.
Yep, I've heard that.
I have a question about number eight.
Okay, let's hear it.
Is Cousin Eddie the world's largest thing, or are they completely unrelated?
It's completely, so it's not completely unrelated. Okay. Cousin Eddie is a figure from popular culture.
I think the question is just fine how it is.
Right. Karen thinks it's just fine.
That's the clue I'm going to give. Cousin Eddie is a figure from popular culture that you may or may not have heard of.
Okay.
Anyway, I
what
am
noise am I hearing?
Anybody else have any questions?
Nope. We're good.
All right. Well, good luck, gang.
All right. Good job. There we go. I'll put Susan and Isabel in the rooms.
Okay.
Thank you, Susan.
You're welcome. You are welcome.
I am very grateful for all your kindness.
Okay, Susan, you're going here. And Isabella, you're going to go to the other one that didn't do so well.
Thank you.
Have fun. And Brian, you should be able to float around rooms now. And I'm going to go to room two, non-essential oils.
This one, I got nothing.
I'm pretty sure number one is Abilene.
Hi, team.
Hi, Susan.
Maybe number two.
Joy and goodness, and if I can
remember. Number one is the tornadoes.
Yeah.
Tornadoes.
Oh, sorry.
And he did not.
I think number two, that's as good an answer as any. Because I honestly could not tell. So, no, number one. But number one, how many tornadoes do we think Kansas gets?
I would say high because he's not specifying if these are actual tornadoes that touch the ground. Not all tornadoes make connection to the land.
201 to 250. Take the top number.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because they often come in swarms. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's only produced one U.S. president.
Sort of like bees. Mm-hmm.
But I would go with C instead of D. I mean, it could be either one. Okay. But they're only 365 days a year, and they do not have tornadoes there every single day.
Correct. But they have many more than one a day when they do have.
Yeah, they can have as many as like 10 or 12 in a day if they don't touch the ground.
Yes.
They
have the most per capita. I know that.
Well, they have to pay tax on them.
So are we going with C or D?
Yes.
C or D.
Yes. I'm cool with either one.
I agree.
Okay. So Abilene.
Abilene.
Abilene for number two? Abilene.
Yeah.
Number three.
Oh, Abilene. Why can't you be true? What?
Number three, some white dude that claims to be Native American.
We had this before.
I got to go help Deborah real quick. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Shame. Deborah was in
one in the
first. So I'm going to move you to sixfold. Is that what it should be?
That's right.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. See you in a little bit. Oops. I don't want to end the meeting for everybody.
See something that said
the tornadoes refer specifically to touchdowns and not just funnel clouds.
I missed it. Okay.
Oh.
Mm.
Well,
Deborah's in the wrong room.
I don't know. Like they can touch down for a couple of seconds and then go away.
I'll go with C, Jim.
I think we should still go with C.
Did you guys get an announcement?
Yeah.
We didn't get your announcement. Yeah.
It's tornadoes that touch down.
We
figured that they were football things.
I thought it was football related, but
right.
Okay, one. We got that. What did you guys put for three? Because I wasn't there.
We don't know. FDR's first vice president.
Yeah,
FDR's first vice president. So it wasn't a woman.
No, it was a man.
It was a Native American man.
Yeah,
is Tilden
Native American?
Was Tilden one of his vice presidents?
I have no idea.
I don't know, but I think that's a good enough.
Never heard the name. But then again, I wouldn't know all the names of
FDR's
vice
presidents.
But Richard, that one I haven't heard.
Richard, did you know those Australian in your history class?
Yeah, in Kansas history class.
Don't worry, Richard. I took U.S. history, and I don't know the names of the vice presidents. So.
Vice president Harris. Okay.
Yeah. And Brown, I think, was later than that.
I don't remember ever having a Native American vice president.
Yeah, he was like a very minor percentage.
Why don't we go ahead and come back to this?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. After we've done all the rest. So
yeah.
Number four.
Number four is Brown versus Board of Education.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Number five.
Would that be Vivian Leigh?
That was who played Mammy.
No, she's from England.
No,
it's Mammy, the black woman who played Mammy won an Oscar.
Hattie McDaniel is her.
Hattie McDaniel, yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, both team. Okay, now Durham, that sure sounds familiar. Durham?
Dunham. Lena?
Who's Lena that? Lena Dunham, yeah.
Who's that?
Lena Dunham from Girlfriends.
From what?
What?
Is it Girlfriends or Girls?
Girls, whichever.
She's have a clue what you guys are talking about. Is that a TV show or a movie star?
Yeah, she's the star and creator.
She talks about her vagina all the time and she pisses people off. Yeah.
Okay, no, never heard of her. All right, number seven. I'm going
to go on mute for a few minutes to get an important phone call.
Have fun.
I'll be back.
She also just came out with a line of plus size clothing that people are complaining are not plus size enough.
Oh, I have not heard that in my circles yet, so.
Well, she doesn't know who I am, so I guess it's all right.
Okay.
It was Bloody Kansas, but Kansas, I think, was free.
I believe you are right.
I think you're right, too.
I think so. It came in with who? Which it was Kansas and...
We know question nine.
It's Nebraska. It's a Kansas-Nebraska act.
Well, then it can't be free because they allowed a free and a slave to go together. So if Nebraska was a free state, then Kansas would have been a slave state.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. I don't think they were a slave state.
I know it was Bloody Kansas. It was an awful mess over there.
It was, but I think it's because it was free and not.
Yeah.
Okay.
Who is Cousin Eddie?
It must be like a raccoon or a possum, giant possum or something. They've got a statue of or something.
But who's Cousin Eddie?
Eddie would be. Cousin Eddie, that's what they call it, is you go by and there's this giant opossum. And they would say
he's saying Cousin Eddie is somebody in popular culture.
Yeah, he was saying it. Cousin Eddie doesn't refer to the item.
Oh.
Yeah. So like, Cousin Eddie be like somebody from the
Adam's family? Adam's
family, or
Eddie Cousin Itch.
Rocky Horror?
No, Eddie. Cousin Eddie.
It is so weird, Richard, to see you in my room.
I'm just looking outside the window and I can see
my cat is still eating his breakfast over there. Poor cat.
And I love how it's daytime outside his window and it's nighttime outside his window because he's on the other side of the world.
Yeah, that makes sense. But he's not sitting.
The world's not flat.
What about, I don't know, Cousin Eddie?
Cousin Eddie Haskell?
Well, it says, what is the world's largest what? So what is the largest? What
they claim is the world's largest.
So like right. A BP or a pair of scissors or a ball of string?
Ball of yarn?
I mean, I thought ball of string or ball of tin foil, but probably ball of string.
String. That sounds like something that would be.
Yeah. Yeah.
Number nine.
Has a hint in it. Smith County, Kansas, doesn't seem very original. It is situated along the Nebraska border and boasts a population of 3,600.
Could the clue be 3,600? In other words, like 360 degrees? Or I don't know. What could be the clue?
He did say was an unfair question.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
I am willing to bet that it is the geographic center of the continental U.S.
Oh yeah, that's a good
guess. That could be. Well, what would be the hint?
360. Yeah.
Yeah.
Did I come up with something because that could have actually been intelligent?
It might be
360.
Honestly, given that we have no other information in Kansas,
I'm glad you're
right. Well, it makes sense.
Don't jump the gun.
According to the Disney movie, the computer will
finish. I think I'm having heart pump.
Yeah. Now, if you could tell me the town Truman Capote traveled to in his research about.
Do we know which number 10 is? What is it?
We either need the town, the family that was murdered, or one of the guys executed.
So I saw the movie.
I think one of my roommates will know if we don't have it ourselves.
Well, ask them.
So I can. Ask him what the answer to the question is.
That's how he talked.
I will, but the reason I guess Geographic Center is that in the Disney movie, the computer wore tennis shoes. That was a question on the quiz show that they were on, and the answer was Lebanon, Kansas.
Right.
Oh, is that the answer?
Kurt Russell, 1960.
Well, 360. Yeah. Yeah. Kurt Russell, but Kurt Russell did not answer that one because he was breaking down at that point, and the dumb guy knew the answer because he had been there. And that's how it works on a trivia team.
Mm-hmm.
All right, if we've got nothing on number 10, I'll go ask. Hang on.
Go ask. I watched the movie. I haven't read the book.
I've never read the movie.
While
Jim is asking, we can debate number three.
It's one of Philip Seymour Hoffman's greatest.
Yeah, number three. Do we have anything for number three?
I mean, I wrote Hilden down, but I have no idea if it's correct because I do not know any of the vice presidents. So
could it be Fremont?
I don't know. I just know he's a white guy and I've seen his picture and I have to go feed the cat. Yes, we're going to go eat dinner. Come with us.
I know that sound.
That's a very
I just sent you a text, Susan.
I see. Vice President. Oh, look at the birdies.
Yeah.
Very nice.
That's what I'm doing while I'm listening to the quizzes. I'm doing photography.
One of the killers is Perry Smith.
No All idea right. who that is.
Given I don't have anything to contribute on it, I'm willing to accept it.
He thinks the name of the family was Clutter.
Okay, number three. I know that Fremont was not Roosevelt, was that who you guys said? But he was kind of in that area, I thought. I he's French. Does that count?
Have any better guess? So.
I don't know.
I mean, are you saying that he was one of Roosevelt's vice president?
No, but I do know he was a vice president. And I thought he was from the Kansas, Missouri area, but I'm not sure. I remember he was involved in the Civil War where he freed the slaves. And then Lincoln said, or whoever it was said, don't free the slaves yet. I'm going to do it in a couple weeks. So you better not do it now. And so
then he would not have been vice president in the 1930s. He would have been long dead.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Does it say year? I didn't realize that. Oh, yeah, there it is. Yeah. I missed the year part. Otherwise, hey, I named a vice president.
Yeah.
Oh, so he wasn't Roosevelt, actually. He was Hoover.
It's even more likely. I don't know who it is.
The more racist.
Hoover's vice president.
Hmm.
Yeah, you got the answer.
Okay. What was it?
If it weren't for time, everything would happen all at once.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And it just did.
So what did we get for number 10?
Perry Smith.
Okay.
Your roommate gave you this?
Yeah, and he believes the name of the family that was killed was Clutter.
Yes, the Clutter, Clutter family.
That's because they didn't know Marie Kondo.
No, it was
right. So what is this? I'm going to look this up when we get all done. So I got to go back and go home.
They believe the two guys went in and murdered the entire family and stole stuff from their safe.
Oh.
Best named town in Kansas.
It's believed that Capote may have had a sexual relationship with one of the murderers. Because he's gay after all.
And the murderer was in prison, so.
Yes, and he went and interviewed him.
Ooh.
I think they were the cutter. I think it was cutter.
Okay, so we're done? We know our Kansas.
Everybody's we have nothing for number three.
Yes, would you say, Brian? Why?
Everybody's about done. Maybe another minute.
Okay.
So can you explain why it's pronounced Kansas and not Arkansas? It's Arkansas, but not Arkansas.
Everything Arkansas here is so the Arkansas River runs through Kansas, and it's called the Arkansas River, like by everybody.
Wow.
King of Kansas, but not in Arkansas.
That's right. One of my favorite memes. America, explain. Why is this Kansas? And why is this Arkansas, not Arkansas?
My favorite city in Kansas is Liberal.
Liberal Kansas. Yep, Liberal Kansas, home of the high pancake school. Feed or whatever. What is it?
Doesn't the Jed Clampett and family come from Kansas?
No,
Arkansas.
They're from Tennessee.
Tennessee. All right. See you there.
All right, Susan, I'm good since I'm in here.
Yeah, you're good. Getting my-
Pretty sure there's a room I didn't visit, which
Robin
makes me a bad host.
Did anybody not see Brian?
I saw Brian.
That's because Brian visited our room five times.
Actually, the reason why is because I kept trying to leave and it would my Chrome wasn't working and it would just push me back into your room.
I think also the rooms, they move.
Yeah, it juggles the order.
It should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but I think sometimes they move in their order, so.
So, Susan, are you going to donate these recordings to the Smithsonian for pandemic history or something?
I've already recorded two, so this is our third one. And let me tell you, they're hilarious.
So why are you recording them?
She's donating them via YouTube.
Yeah, they're on YouTube. Right.
What, Susan? Well, I was asking why you were recording them.
Because they're hilarious.
So this was my surprise. We went out to dinner for the first time with friends since the pandemic, because we're all vaccinated, by the way. And Bonnie says, Rob, I watched that video where you're playing the trivia game. It is fascinating. I'm only halfway through, but I have to finish it. I was like, really?
I put them on and I just have them there and I can listen to you guys and I can get the jokes and stuff that you said that, you know, got somebody else over talked to you or something. And I think, oh my God, you guys are so funny. These are going to be great when I'm old.
Oh, wait a minute. You listen to these again?
Yes. They're great.
I don't think Susan,
Susan, are you really that bored?
No. They're wonderful. They make me laugh.
You can only watch Poirot so many times.
Yeah, I rewatched the one last week when we were talking about the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile, and it made me laugh 10 times more than I laughed the original time.
Yeah, and you know what? Exactly. And the person who's reading the category now will go into the room because it only records the room I'm in. So you could, if you're not in that room, you could hear what we did.
Right. So that's what I did. I fast forwarded through the parts I had experience and I only did that. Right. So then I found out who was trash talking to me. So yeah, I have a list. I'm looking at you, Mike.
Looking at you, Mike. But yeah. So Rob, you had a friend that was actually listening to the thing.
She's watching it. Yeah. She that day she had gotten halfway through it. So she saw the first category and mine. I went second. And we spent a lot of time at my wife's annoyance, I think, talking, you know, trying to guess the answers, the other people that hadn't watched it.
I missed last week, so I'll have to take advantage of
it's hilarious.
Recording and go back and watch.
Who knows, Susan? Maybe you'll get a contract for a television show.
Well, it'd have to have all of you guys in it because I'm not
exactly going
to
be myself. It's going to be a reality show.
So Caspian says that I was foretold. It was foretold we would win. who has six now, it needs to be four? Yep. You lost 2 points?
What?
Yeah.
That's lame.
I don't know who was counting, but yeah.
Well, thanks for being honest, guys.
Thank you, guys.
What happened? That
was nice. Integrity, gang. Integrity.
Should change the name.
All right, go ahead.
Yeah, we have integrity, but we're losers. Something like that.
They're trying to get new members on their team.
Yeah, but it was foretold. Oh, yeah? Sorry. Not really necessarily. Okay, go ahead, Brian.
Okay. Does anybody mind if I read the answers and then dump the answers?
I don't care. Yeah, go for it.
Okay, cool. So, question one, tornadoes, how many do we have? Okay, well, it's A, 96 tornadoes touched down in Kansas a year.
It's 100.
All right. Question two, where is Eisenhower's Presidential Library? It's in Abilene, also the home of the Greyhound Hall of Fame.
Wow.
For the buses?
I didn't know that was a thing.
I'm going to have to go there now.
It's the dogs. Yeah. The poor dogs. Actually, they kind of take care of them. I don't know about it. It may be awful. I don't know.
Greyhound bus started in Hibbing, Minnesota.
All right. So, question three. The vice president was Charles Curtis. He was a member of the Kaw Nation.
Thank you, Karen.
Really?
Last name acceptable?
Curtis. Yeah.
Vice president
last Curtis. Name is fine. Last name
how
fine.
Much?
So did Mike. They were talking about it when Kamala was, that's why they were specific about the wording of what the first was.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
When Kamala was sworn in.
Yep. All right. The answer to number four is Brown versus Board of Education.
Yay.
There's a nice little museum here in town.
And just so everyone knows, Robin gets to keep her license.
All right. Number five is Hattie McDaniel.
Yay.
Woo.
All right.
That's number a candidate note.
Yep. That is.
Oh, you know, never mind. I know who she is. Never mind. It was the other one, I don't know.
Mammy, she played Mammy.
Yeah, yep, that's right. Other Kansans of note are Barry Sanders, I guess. I don't know.
That's the full list? Okay.
Yeah. Other Kansans of note are few and far between.
Number six, Barack Obama.
Barack Hussein Obama.
That's right.
What? I knew that name.
Oh, yes.
That was one of our categories. That was a trivia question I had ages, like 5 years ago when we were just starting.
5 years ago, yeah.
I knew that name.
5 COVID years, yep.
That's not Jeff Dunham's mom.
Jeff Dunham.
Yep.
Oh, my God.
I was guessing Lena Dunham.
Yeah, we
I
did too.
I cannot believe I didn't. They talked me out of it. Sorry, you guys, but you're
maybe she had
I'm
more kids
you under the bus because yeah, they talked did. Me out of it.
All right, okay. What was I on? Number seven was free.
Remember the, what you put down for the name of your first roommate?
Hmm.
Yes.
I'm ignoring that and moving on. Number seven was free. Kansas entered the Union as a free state. That's why Missouri kept coming over and messing us up and burning down towns and stuff, but John Brown was doing his thing too, so it's fine. Number eight, Ball of Twine.
Yay!
And
this is hey, Leonard.
This is very contested because it depends on the type of twine, but I worded the question, I think. I worded the question to get to this answer, so.
Claims.
Okay, number nine. The question that's I heard everybody coming up with stuff for, including my hometown and all that stuff. No, I'm not from that boring ass place. Forget it.
The center, isn't it?
It's the geographic center of the lower 48.
Oh.
Yeah. Yay. Bruce Springsteen talked about it in the commercial.
And
so where is the hint?
Yeah, where's the hint?
360.
Origin.
What? Oh, I thought 360.
Huh? Oh, really obscure hint.
Where's the origin?
I know. I know it's
you mean part of the word original?
Brian, no, origin, if you hadn't given center. Us that hint, we may have gotten the correct answer.
Yeah, but where is origin in the statement?
Original. Original.
Well, that's what I just said. So part of the word original is origin, and that was the hint. Okay.
Yeah. I got it from the word 360.
I made no statements about how good the hint was. True. Yeah. I just said it was a hint.
The answer right. Capital of
original
for.
Is O, which is yeah. the center of a bullseye. Right.
That's right. Okay, and question 10. Good on you if you got it, just because I ran out of Kansas trivia. It was the Clutter family in Holcomb, Kansas, and the killers were Dick Hickok and Perry Smith.
Yeah. Holcomb.
So there you go. There's my Kansas trivia. You guys can all forget it after this, all right. And you'll never
that
need
was
it.
Great. Again.
Forget what?
Well, I had another Kansas trivia for you. Don't you remember when the State Board of Education said that for Kansas schools, pi would be equal to just no, with no decimal points, a whole number, because it was too complicated for the kids?
The Kansas Board of Education has done some stuff.
I remember that.
I can do a whole category on just dumbass stuff that the Kansas Board of Education stuff.
My ex-boyfriend's uncle, his father was one of the attorneys on that lawsuit.
All right.
Oh, my little claim to fame there.
How about a two name, a city with two words in its name that's equivalent to a city with the same two words in its name in another state?
Kansas City,
right. As opposed to Kansas City, Missouri.
I'm nine. How do they calculate that? Is it just the furthest east and west and the furthest north south, regardless of the actual area?
Whole country and they put it on a little point of a pin.
Yeah, that's what I'm wondering. Or did they do that with a map? I don't know.
I wonder. Withdrawing your special powers, Brian. I hope you enjoyed it.
Do you know Brian? No.
Okay, let's go for scores. So
it's on Wikipedia.
Very good, Brian. I'm glad we got to that state. We hadn't done that state. I want to hopefully get to all of them. So keep that in mind, whoever else is out there.
Okay.
It was for total. Remember, you can see which ones we've already done by looking at the Facebook link I put up there. I have everything in there we've done. So.
Did you just put the Facebook link?
It's on our Facebook page. Facebook. Okay. It was foretold we would win. How'd you do?
Eight.
Not bad. Okay.
And this time it is correct.
Okay. I will trust that. And sixfold decrease in chicken for breakfast.
Three.
What?
But we scored 10 for having fun.
Three.
Okay.
That's what I was afraid we were going to get.
So Washington versus Worcestershire.
Seven.
And this way to the great egress of no regrets or frets for snowy egrets.
Eight.
And non-essential oils, which is the team I was on.
Seven.
Wow. Okay, so here's your handy dandy scores, showing you off our scores. Eight. 15, 16, 14, and 12. So sixfold. Got some work to do. Do we need to take a 5-minute break?
I could use a break.
Sure.
Okay. We'll come back with break. 5 minutes.
Those team scores look like a pretty decent player character.
Okay. Susan, low number charisma.
Susan? Which Susan?
Always dump charisma.
Susan?
Which yeah. Susan? The warlock, how very dare you?
Okay.
Who's up next, Susan?
Oh.
Okay.
Hey.
Nope. I think with this, I am going to head on out.
Who said that?
You lasted long enough.
Sarah.
Deserting us. Oh, dear.
Yeah.
You missed a great category.
Mike Wolf is next.
I think I'm going to listen to the questions for the next one to see if I can help my team at all, and then I'm going to head out as well.
Uh-oh. Okay. Are you fading? You should
definitely stay for the next category. It's going
to
be awesome.
Did you need me to use the bonus? Did the person show up? I didn't remember who it was.
No, she didn't.
Okay, so I need to pull it out.
Yeah, you'll be needed, I'm sure.
Okay. Which version did you get, Kelly?
I got Moderna.
Yeah, Team Moderna.
I had Pfizer.
We have Moderna. Pfizer.
Yeah, both of us got Moderna too.
I got Moderna on Saturday. I got Pfizer. I got Moderna just Saturday, and the person in front of me had a seizure.
Mm-hmm. Seriously?
Really? Yeah. It was in a car. It was at Dodger Stadium.
Oh my gosh.
And I got the shot like just 1 minute before she had her seizure. So that's like, oh, I hope I don't get one too. Her sister was with her, so she was able to go get help. And it was run by the LA Fire Department. So
that's good.
But they did have to take her to the hospital, and her sister had to drive the car away from there.
Did you find out anything about that? Was she prone to seizures?
I would think if someone's prone to seizures, they wouldn't be driving a car.
Yeah. I got mine yesterday.
She was only 25 too.
I got mine yesterday and it was like really quick and easy. I didn't really feel it. And then I just had to sit and then they gave me a candy bar. So.
Whoa.
They don't give candy bars at Dodger Stadium.
You got a candy bar? I didn't get no candy bar.
Yeah, it was at the local, it was in Monterey at one of their clinics, and there was a lady, she was like, we have lollipops, we have candy bars.
Wait a minute.
We have candy. Crackers.
Wait a minute. They weren't in a shady looking van, were they?
No, it was a nice lady with like a little, like, I don't know, like a little.
Did she have
basket.
A roll of duct tape?
No, she had a badge on that said volunteer hospital.
Uh-huh. Oh yeah, I like the story. I can print a badge like that.
Side of my van and help me lift this.
She was inside the building.
Okay, she wasn't wearing a yellow shirt, was she?
She was wearing
an orange jumper.
No, she was wearing the hospital, she was in scrubs.
Okay, that's how they get you.
You can buy scrubs at Walmart.
You can't get scrubs anywhere or volunteer shirts or any of that.
Get scrubs at Walmart.
I know.
You end up in a bathtub and ice water the next morning.
If you see a volunteer in a yellow shirt, run away. They're a Scientologist. Okay.
Has everybody heard
you
about
didn't the, get the vaccine?
Has she everybody heard about the free Krispy Kreme donuts if you've been vaccinated?
Yeah, I will get vaccinated.
I tried that. They said it wouldn't. They said I was too young.
I will gladly get vaccinated multiple times if they don't give me the Krispy Kreme donuts.
But they supposedly will give you one every day for the rest of the year. I mean, they're going to go bankrupt if everyone gets them.
They don't check. It's literally you show up, you show your vaccine card, they give you a donut.
Yeah,
it's like amazing. That's how it works.
Krispy Kreme, it's like an hour to get in.
There's not one close enough to
your point. Can I get them to give me a Dunkin' Donut at Krispy Kreme?
I tried the Krispier. I don't really like. I don't know. I had my first Krispy Kreme donut on last Sunday, and I don't know. I wasn't that impressed. I'm sorry.
Yeah, people at work bring
them
in.
It was a little too sweet.
And they make a big deal about it. And I agree with Carl. I like Dunkin' Donuts just fine.
Dunkin' Donuts is much better.
It's just a different kind of donut.
Dunkin' Donuts.
I'm not going to turn down
because
I think all of you are wrong because Krispy Kreme originated in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And we get free donuts whenever our sports.
Dunkin' Donuts, the original one, is in Quincy, Mass.
I like the old fashioned, I will say.
Not that good.
As a Canadian,
you like Tim Hortons?
Tim Hortons.
No, Dunkin' Donuts is not better.
Well, but do you have a Krispy? Do you have
you
a donut
clearly
challenge?
Not
for a mom and pop place by my house better than that.
Do you have a donut challenge where we have?
We should have a donut category for trivia.
I would gladly do a donut category.
That would be an awesome category. I love donuts.
Here we have a Krispy Kreme challenge, which benefits the Juvenile Diabetes Association.
Oh, Jesus!
I here's the challenge. You have to run 5 miles within 1 hour, and you run 2.5 miles to the Krispy Kreme store. You have to eat a dozen donuts and run back 2.5 miles.
Oh, that's 1 hour.
Later, we will have the Great American Smoke-Off to benefit the American Lung Association.
There is a bicycle race like that in, it's some Midwestern state. It's called the Tour de Donuts.
Heard of that.
And you have to drink like a certain amount of water and eat a certain number of donuts.
That sounds painful.
See, this is
it is like you're throwing up all the time and just
good.
Like Iowa, I think.
I think donuts while you're riding actually is pretty good as long as they're the light kind. Like if they're the heavy cakey donuts, it's really hard.
The raised ones actually have more fat than the other ones.
Yeah, it's like it's more about like the consistency when it's in your stomach because it's hard to ride on a stomach.
They feel lighter, but they're not.
If you were doing an endurance race, you probably want yeast donuts, and Coca-Cola actually tastes freaking amazing.
Right, but this, what this happens though is that you get points based on speed, but also on how much of the stuff you ate. So people are trying to eat more stuff.
I personally like donut holes a bit better. I don't know why, but
there you go.
If you want
the Krispy Kreme donut holes are really, really good.
If you want a terrifying challenge, eat a dozen donuts and then do 50 sit-ups.
I saw
parts of this. This is awesome.
Monitor lizard.
Whoa.
I saw that on TikTok this morning.
He wants
that
donut.
That is amazing.
That is so awesome.
Oh my God.
What country is that in?
Oh my God, he's getting way up there.
That maybe looks like Thailand.
Where is this? It's in like the Philippines or somewhere.
That is an intrepid lizard.
No, where?
I think it was in like the Philippines or Thailand.
I would think Indonesia is where mother.
It says Thailand.
That's horrifying.
If you look at the language on some of the like the sponges or the chips or whatever they are.
Thailand.
So why did they hide? Isn't that like normal for them?
I know, but I wouldn't really want to run into that in a grocery store
or anywhere.
How do they get it out?
To get to the icy machine.
Maybe
they lure it out with an icy. Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Not they like dead animals.
I mean, pitchfork. I think you'd be surprised if that was like a 6 foot dog up there.
A pitchfork.
Like, you'd be surprised if a 6 foot anything was up there on the shelf.
All right, so let's do quick announcements and let's we need to do a group picture. And so
now I want a donut.
Newman, why don't you go first?
Okay, I don't know what we're releasing tomorrow, if it's anything. I can't remember, but we might be trying to get Sam Harris on the show. So if anyone here is a buddy of Sam Harris, I can maybe use your help.
I don't know.
Okay.
I would have needed it if I did.
I don't know who that is. I'm sorry.
That's good. Good for you.
You don't wake up with Sam Harris? That's the name of his podcast. That's the name of his podcast. Waking up.
Leonard, you not like Sam Harris?
Correct.
Leonard does not like Sam Harris.
Sam Harris has some problems, and we can talk about him in private later.
I don't know him at all. I haven't heard his podcast. I haven't seen him speak, but I hear that he's
controversial.
He's very popular.
Don't ask him about IQ studies.
He's very popular.
And on Google, it says he's into terrorism studies.
And many people that like him really, really like him.
Concerningly like him.
Well, not in a sexual or creepy way, but
he has a huge fan base.
As in a fanatical way.
In a fanatical way.
He's kind of like
a
bracer.
He was one of the original new atheists, quote unquote.
He's a lot like Jordan Peterson.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was going to say.
But completely different.
He has the habit of making very controversial statements, and then when called out on it, he will accuse people of not understanding him.
Oh, that's not okay.
Misunderstanding him, and I find his approach very dishonest. He, for example, at one point he supported torture, and then when he was called out on it, he said, "Well, I didn't really mean that." I mean, and then he tried to backtrack, and then when people criticize him for that, he says, he accuses people of being against him and deliberately misreading him.
And I think that what Mano's describing is simultaneously incredibly true and accurate and one of his better characteristics.
Yeah. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. This guy.
Well, it gets a lot worse.
Because this is
being like Sam.
This is being recorded, and we're going to get lots of wonderful comments.
Anyway, Jim, so good luck getting him on the show.
He's not horrible and he's not awful. Just practice your skeptical thinking tools. That's all I'm going to say.
I want to know about this Peterson guy. He was on, he did interview of
we're going on the off topic. Festival.
Just don't forget to say don't at me.
Jordan Peterson interviewed Mark Edwards
going off
just a
topic.
Few weeks ago, and I
really? Yeah, Jordan Peterson is.
If we can be unrecorded, I can tell you a lot of things.
Later, after the game, though. After the game.
Yeah, Jordan Peterson has even put his hand into math crankery. So
Jordan Peterson uses philosophical word salad like Deepak Chopra uses scientific sounding word salad.
Yeah.
Okay. Perfect, Rob. Well, he did an interview of Mark Edward a few months ago.
Really? For what?
For his podcast.
By the way, if you want Sam Harris demanded from Noam Chomsky that he debate him. And Chomsky kept turning him down because he thought he didn't think much of Sam Harris, but Sam kept insisting. And finally Chomsky agreed. And then they put the debate online and Chomsky really gave Harris, handed him his hat. I mean, he really, Sam Harris went into an argument with Chomsky, not realizing that Chomsky is really one of the sharpest social analysts. And it was a pitiful performance by Harris. And of course, he accused Chomsky of misunderstanding him and deliberately distorting him.
Do you have a link to that debate?
I can send you that link. I can find it.
I mean, I saw the email exchange, but I never saw the debate.
Oh, the transcript of the debate, yeah.
Well, no, transcript of the email exchange they had.
Sorry, it was the email exchange. The whole thing was done via email.
Yeah, it wasn't a debate. He was trying to set up a debate. They never got that far.
No,
debate via email.
By email. So it was back and forth. Actually, so that was very informative. It was a lengthy email exchange. I can send the link to people.
Okay.
I've read
that. So that was Go Fact Yourself. Thanks, Stephen.
Sorry.
Richard Saunders.
Oh, hello.
Hello, Richard.
Hello. Coming up on the Skeptic Zone podcast episode number 652 on the 11th of April, we have, hopefully, I'm trying to line up, an interview with Brian Dunning and Steve Roberts from Melbourne, both on the topic of UFOs in Australia. We also have the latest skeptical update from the skeptical news at the Australian Skeptics. And this week in our Trove segment, we're going to look at references to the word debunk with a fascinating piece about written 70 years ago about quack medical devices. All that and more on the Skeptic Zone podcast at skepticzone.tv.
Very well. That's how it's done. Very good. Kyle Polish is in here, so we can't ask him. Yes, Deborah.
Richard.
You're on mute.
Richard, do you have anything exciting in the works for episode 666?
You know what? It didn't even occur to me, but I'll see what I can do.
That'll be the dice game.
Since Kyle isn't here, I just want to recommend that if you haven't listened to his QAnon episode, I would recommend it.
Yeah, Kyle Polish does Data Skeptic, and he's done three podcasts, three different topics. He's waiting to see for people to vote on what they want him to do a series on, and they're all good. So I don't know how I would vote. So
yeah. That's coming up. I just listened to the QAnon one, and I really liked it because it was more analytical oriented.
Are those the most recent episodes?
Yeah, the three most
recent
ones.
Yeah,
it's Skeptic.
Oh my God, if anyone has HBO, I am watching QAnon Into the Storm. It is very disturbing.
Good. I've only watched three. I've got three more to go, but I know what's going to happen because I've already seen the interviews with the guy.
All right, no spoilers. I'm up to episode 4 out of.
Okay, so I won't tell you that Q is actually.
Q is actually Q. It's John DeLancey. What a shock.
It's Luke's father.
This is unrelated, but Netflix has a miniseries on the Isabella Gardner museum heist.
Oh, I read the whole Wikipedia page for her and for the museum and for the heist.
I'm really excited for that, by the way. It was really good.
Rabbit hole.
Yeah.
What was it, Kelly?
People, the Perry Mason stuff.
Oh, I just said that John DeLancey's coming back to Star Trek for Picard season 2.
Yes, I saw that.
And you're welcome,
bud. Teaser trailer.
You're welcome.
All Rob's fault.
Rob did it.
He took care of it.
I interviewed him before Picard was starting, and for the Skeptical Inquirer article. And when we stopped, officially, I said, "I'm a Trek fan. I have to ask you this." Picard is showing trailers. Are you going to be invited at all? And he said, oh, they'll never take me. I'm too old. How are they going to explain an old Q? And I said, well, he feels bad for Patrick Stewart. He feels bad for Picard because Picard is aged. So he just makes himself look older. And he, oh my God.
Good job, Rob.
So my speculation is he went to, you know, the production crew and said, hey, this is how you can have me on the show.
What other possible explanation occurred to most Star Trek fans?
But it didn't occur to John DeLancey, which is
it
freaking amazing.
It only occurred to most Star Trek fans after Rob put it through.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. Okay, so the last announcement, April's got an announcement. Announcement, April!
Okay, well, it's not a podcast or anything to particularly check out, but a state publication in my home state of Idaho does this thing every year called the Accomplished Under 40 Award, where they pick 40 people who, in their estimation, have achieved success before the age of 40. And while I'm not totally sure I actually meet that standard, they did select me for that award.
Whoa.
With the help of Susan, who was kind enough to furnish me with one of my letters of recommendation.
Wow.
Oh, nice.
Isn't that great?
Nicely done. Nicely done.
And the letter I wrote to you was totally legit.
It did appear to me. I couldn't detect
it. No, it really was. I mean, it was a legit. I used GSOW and all the amazing things she's written. I'm sure they got that letter and said, oh my God, this woman is going to be number one at her 40. Because it was pretty cool. I was like, wow, look at all April's done.
But yeah,
that was great.
I'll drop a link to the at least preliminary, all they've released so far is like a list of the winners, but there'll be a more lengthy sort of write-up of each of us.
That's just really cool.
Very cool.
Congratulations.
I think that's fantastic. And if you want to find any of the videos that the last couple we've done, I'm just putting them on our YouTube channel. There's nothing special about them. I don't even think they have your names on them for some strange reason. It just is pictures of us. So, but I find them wonderfully entertaining. And we've got like 25 views.
No, I asked somebody about that. There's a setting, you have to go to the web for your account, and there's a setting to show names when it's being recorded or not. So
that's why they're not showing.
But that's probably just as well.
I don't really care.
I don't think anybody really wants their name.
I'm fine with that. I mean,
okay, so no names. It's just anonymous people talking. If you really want who we are, then that's fine. So picture, and then let's go. Leonard.
Are we ready? We got a couple people not on the screen, Susan and Paula and Peggy and Karen.
Yeah, that's my choice right now.
Intentional.
Okay, that's good.
Okay.
All right. We ready?
Mm-hmm.
3, 2, 1, picture. Picture. Okay.
Okay, good. Thank you. All right, so we have Mike Wolfe up next, and I need to find you on the screen so I can make you some
power
sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions, sesame. There you are.
Hello.
To all beef patty special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions on a sesame seed bun. Got it.
And you made right. Ben the co-host.
Oh, I did. Oh. Sorry, well, I hope you tried it while you had it.
Oh, it's gone.
Let me show you all what I was doing just while that whole segment was going on. Yeah, I just put a link in the thing. I was just doing some photography next to me.
He was doing some thing.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
Are you multitasking?
Or donuts?
I'm multitasking, yeah.
Ooh.
High resolution photography of donuts.
Is that the Italian paper?
It is.
Nice.
Wow.
I like it.
I didn't see it. Hold on.
Nice.
Oh, and there's a baby.
Yeah. Oh.
You're gorgeous.
Oh, aren't that beautiful?
The paper's amazing.
It's great paper. I love it. Yeah.
All right, Mike.
Made up out of
letters. I got that stuff. Okay. So this is another secret category. Once you figure out what the category is, it will help you answer the other questions.
Ooh.
See.
Okay, question one. What, and this one had to be changed because of our new question rules. What is the first name of George's fiance who died from licking stamps on the TV show Seinfeld.
We should mute us.
Oh, sorry. I'll mute everybody now. 3, 2, 1. Mike, you'll have to unmute.
Okay. Question 2. Under what pseudonym did Benjamin Franklin publish his almanac? And we want the full first and last name for this question. Question 3. What was the name of the other vampire slayer on the Buffy show who was played by the same actress who played Arnold Schwarzenegger's daughter in the movie True Lies? So basically, I know there's may have been other vampire slayers on Buffy the Vampire Slayer, but this is one particular one played by that particular actress. Question 4. What is the name of the large film studio at the Brooklyn Navy Yard? It is the largest studio complex outside of Hollywood in the United States, and they shot part of that Joker movie there. Question 5. Who was the singer who, along with the drummer from the band Chic and the guitar player and bass player from Duran Duran, formed the supergroup The Power Station? The singer from The Power Station. Number 6. What was the name of Clint Eastwood's character in that movie where he steals a bunch of Nazi gold with Don Rickles, Telly Savalas, and a bunch of other guys? We just want the name of the character, not the name of the movie necessarily. Number 7, who is the animated character who is the wife of Hank and the mother of Bobby? She was voiced by one of the actresses from those Singing Nun movies. Number 8, what is the identity that was taken over by Jason Todd, then Tim Drake, then Stephanie Brown, also by some others? And by identity, you'll have to figure out what that means. But it's obvious if you know what I'm talking about. And number 9, what is the world's largest inland body of water? And number 10, what is the first name of Ingrid Bergman's famous younger daughter? She was in that David Lynch movie. And that's it. And there's the secret category. Once you figure, they all are in a category. Once you figure out the category, many of the questions will be much easier. That's all. And hopefully, do I need to?
Any questions?
This is really good, Mike.
Are you staying around, Kelly?
Some people will have an advantage in this category, but I think everyone will get 10 out of 10.
I don't like it.
I like it.
Okay, here we go. Oh, I got some people. When did Paula get here? I didn't see Paula arrive. Mm-hmm. Who let Paula in? Who let Paula in?
Who? I stepped out and came back, Susan. I'll need to be reassigned, please.
Okay, so you are in the great group. Me too. Yes. Chris And then Newman goes
Thank
to
you.
Non-essential oils.
Wait,
words that people would normally say. All right, so I'm going to go to the egress place. All right.
But dudes, don't you get what the common denominator is?
Yeah,
it's totally, it's too, super simple. You guys will get it super easily.
It's us.
Yay! Us.
What?
Yes, it's all us. These names.
Everything. Yeah, the only one I had was Richard Saunders and Peggy.
Okay, I've got to look at this. So hold on a second. I got to look.
You? Okay, so I know two.
The first one is Susan.
Yay!
Yep.
What?
Yep.
Yeah, Susan.
Susan was George's fiance who died by licking the envelopes.
And Susan, you're number one because you're number one.
That's right.
And oh, number two cool. is poor Richard, otherwise known as Richard Saunders.
Oh, yes. Richard Saunders.
Yes.
I guess I didn't really look at the questions.
And number three is
I don't Faith. Know who that is.
That's Faith.
Faith?
Okay.
Yes.
Faith.
Number four.
Brooklyn Studio. I don't know.
Or it's, I don't know. It's the name of somebody in trivia, though.
But okay, we come back let's to think it. About that. Name think of about somebody that, huh? who plays trivia here. I don't know.
Not a clue.
Huh. Power station I've never heard of.
Maybe it's just the last name of somebody.
Well, so far, they're all first names.
And they, well, except for the full name, which was Richard Saunders.
Right.
They shot part of that Joker movie there. I wonder if there's some clue embedded in the way that's structured.
Well, the only Joker movie I know of is Joker.
So,
which I just watched.
I'm going to go before my facial expressions get.
Yeah, go.
Fair hints.
Mask yourself.
Okay, could it be Robin? No. Could it be Leonard? No. Could it be Karen?
Oh, you'd have to go through 40 names.
And how did he know who was going to play tonight? I guess it's just
people. Well, it's got to be, he probably chose fairly regular players.
The regulars, yeah, and probably the more well-known people. So SOW folks and stuff.
Yeah. Okay, so let's see who the other five. The other
so who's Clint Eastwood's character? Does anyone know that movie?
Kelly's Heroes.
Oh.
One of the greatest movies of all time.
Six?
I've never seen it.
Okay. Oh, you got to see it.
Seven.
Seven is Peggy.
Peggy Hill.
How about five?
Don't know five.
Okay. I actually thought that was Huey Lewis, but I could not be wrong.
We have a Huey?
No, I don't think so. So it's probably wrong.
Number seven, the animated That's character. That's Peggy.
Yeah, it's Peggy Hill.
Peggy Hill.
That one I knew.
Identity that was taken by Jason Todd, Tim Drake, and Stephanie Brown.
I think that's Robin.
What are they talking about there?
As in Batman and Robin.
Oh.
Stephanie? Which
one? Number eight?
Stephanie?
Eight.
There was a female Robin?
Yes, there was a female Robin.
Okay,
number nine.
Now, wait a minute. Stop with number eight. I mean, stop with number nine before you say it. Give Susan a chance to think about it.
Yeah, you should know this one.
Come on, don't give.
What is the world's largest inland body of water?
Okay.
You know, I think you know this person.
Probably.
Well, you know the name. You've heard the name.
You've heard the name.
Well, because
oh, Caspian.
The Caspian.
I was thinking
sea.
America.
The Caspian Sea. No, it's the
I was thinking
largest.
It was going to be America.
It's
North
the
America.
World. The world's largest, not America.
Oh, I wonder what the other teams are
us.
Doing now. Are they laughing?
It's us.
And then number 10,
Isabella Rossellini.
Isabella
Rossellini.
Isabella.
Okay. Oh, that's funny.
Amazingly beautiful actress.
So we don't have four and five then, right?
Okay, four and five. Let's think of some regular players and see. Is there a Robert? Could Robert fit on either of those or Rod?
Robert Palmer?
Palmer.
Who the singer along with the drummer from Chic and the
Is that Palmer? Is that possible?
Could that be Palmer Studios in Brooklyn?
Robert Palmer.
Number question five.
Really?
Oh, yes, Robert Palmer is a singer. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I know he's a singer.
Yes. I think that's Robert Palmer.
So, number four.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, could that be Leonard? A film studio, largest studio complex outside of the US, or Tramiel?
I think this is going to be a last name, probably.
How about four? Could it be Carl?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, who else do we have that we could pick?
Who's got a last name that would make sense for a studio name?
Okay, let's see.
Aaron, all the other ones have been first names.
James. Jane. Mono. I'll name people. You tell me what fits.
Yeah, film studio. Warken.
April. Kevin.
Mocker. No.
Gail.
I don't think so.
Jamie.
Adrian. Miles.
Janine. Romero.
That Jeff? Sounds like a studio name.
Romero. Be.
Okay. Jeff. Julie. Lou. Jim Newman. James.
Newman Studios.
But Brian, all the rest of them are first names.
Brian. I know. No.
Deborah.
Just doesn't seem like a studio would have a first
name. Avi. Alan.
Well, because Romero is also a last name.
Yeah.
Avi, Ben. Who's here? Who's not here today? Wendy.
Her last name is Steiner. Steiner could be a Brooklyn studio.
I like Wendy, Romero.
I like Steiner.
Paula.
Is there a Gerbic studio?
We've already got Susan. I like Steiner Studios.
I had no idea. I don't watch Seinfeld. So
sounds like a Brooklyn kind of a thing.
Yeah. They're doing their wedding invitations, and he bought some cheap envelopes.
Yeah. She poisoned herself to death by licking them.
Yeah. She died from licking the cheap.
It's funny. As he was reading the questions, I go, okay, the first one. I saw every episode of Seinfeld, but that was so long ago and I have never watched the reruns. And Susan is what I wrote down. It clicked.
Yeah. And then when did you guys figure out that it's us?
I figured the pattern out by number
right
three.
Away.
Really?
As soon as it was three. Susan and Isabella.
I had Susan and Richard Saunders, so that kind of made it click.
Oh, Susan, that's too funny. That's Richard, really good.
I'm like, this Susan, really Richard good, Saunders, like... Faith, wait a minute.
I figured that out.
And we've had the Richard Saunders factoid previously.
Oh, yeah. Did we?
I don't remember that. I'm not sure that number four, we've got the right answer. I don't think we have the right answer for four,
but.
Well, let me think a second. Who else?
I think four, the Wolf only Studios, one we're worried
Wolf
about.
Wolf Studios. Adrian?
I think number four is Steiner Studios.
Okay.
But all the rest are first names, you guys.
Oh, we got not well first or
well
first
except for
last.
The one that's except for the previous one that is explicitly a full name, Richard Saunders
and Robert Richard
Palmer. And Robert Palmer.
All Richard, no. Or Richard, so Richard, I don't know.
So so what we're missing is the so what's missing in that question is the last name. Mm-hmm. So they're not all first names.
Yeah.
Okay, you are correct. I'm still gonna. Okay. Never mind. I have no reason to say Romero, except so go for it. Steiner. Okay, got it.
I can't imagine what else.
Steiner sounds like Queens.
And we got time. Keep naming people, Susan. Maybe something else will click.
Well, I named everybody who's here. So who's not here? Wendy's not here. She normally plays. Adrian's not here.
So the question is, did Mike rearrange the questions based on who showed up?
He might have had one for everybody.
Oh. And of course, today we had three Steiners. Have you been practicing your singing, Rob Palmer?
Only in the shower when no one else is in the house.
I'm gonna be licking envelopes later.
I think Rob Palmer was the one who sang that song "Addicted to Love."
That's correct. Yeah, it's Robert.
Addicted to Love.
Oh, Robert.
I call myself Rob because
of
Palmer.
That. Yeah.
You don't have to be Robert. Well, Palmer.
Otherwise the women just
That's right. All right. I'm simply irresistible and addicted to love.
That one. Simply irresistible.
My sister and two cousins worked in the same place I did, and they, those commercials with Pepsi for that and all came out when we were all working together, and she so wanted to do a lip sync kind of a thing with me playing Robert Palmer and them dressed with the red lipstick and the tight black dresses, and we never did it. I wish we had.
That's a good story, and is Isabella GSOW? Maybe no. It's more, okay, she's not. Okay, so it's just trivia. It's not
GSOW. Peggy's not. No,
neither is Caspian.
Robin's not. The letters?
Yeah, Isabella and Peggy are from my bubble outside of
optics.
Can you read the
only people that are GSOW on here? Rob and myself.
We have Susan, Richard Saunders, Faith, Steiner, me, Kelly, Peggy, Robin, Caspian, and Isabella.
Okay, so we got them all.
Oh, that was great. So Steiner,
I'm not happy about
I-N-E-R.
Yeah, I mean, unless we can think of some other name that we're just not remembering that sounds more like it.
I think it sounds good.
Oh, I think there's just, there's a famous With a K Studios.
Yeah.
With a K.
But is that in the at the Brooklyn Navy Yard?
Yeah.
I thought With that was the one under the arch in St. Louis.
Ah, that could be.
Or is it the top of the arch?
Wait a minute. Who is Mike friends with in this group?
Everybody now. But I don't know how we acquired him. He just was here.
I say we stick with what we got.
Because remember, he had to come up. He had to come up with. These aren't necessarily the famous people, but they're names he had to come up with a question for.
Yeah, right.
So maybe he couldn't think of something for somebody else.
Oh, we already had a category on Carl with a K, so you burned out all possibilities there.
I sure did.
What? Did I miss this?
Yeah, I had a Carl with a K.
You not there on the Carl with a K week?
No, I don't think so.
That was really hard not to come up with a bunch of German murderers. I think we only had one German murderer.
What?
We did have one German murderer.
Yeah, that's the rule. Anytime you see someone named Carl in a movie, especially if it's spelled with a K, they're always the killer, a hunchback, deformed, a Nazi.
Well, there was one that was a murderer, serial killer.
Yep.
But one was a car. Yeah, I did a category.
The bad guy in Ghost, Carl.
I did a Wendy category. I did a Jane category. What else did
you did Karen.
And I did. Karen was first.
And thank you for not bringing up that it now is a vulgar.
And
word.
I think it's kind of
being reduced.
I'm still changing my name. I was at the bank the other day. They drilled my safety deposit box of 50 years without contacting me. And when I went in, they had no form for me to fill out to retrieve my belongings. And I was very aware of staying perfectly calm because every time I lose my shit, even something like that, they roll their eyes and they look at each other. Karen, it is fucked up.
What did they do to your? What did they do to
Why
your
deposit box?
I'll tell you later, Susan.
Okay, okay.
But I was staying so calm.
Yeah, that's right. This is being recorded for posterity. That's true.
Yeah. Okay, okay. So let's go back. We did really good.
Oh, I'm sorry for my language. Sorry for my potty mouth.
It's all Mike's fault. Don't worry about it.
What? Yeah, now Susan cannot monetize
category.
It. You can't monetize it.
All of these.
It was really good.
We're done.
We got it.
Boom.
I'm sure we did not get more than
10. Miles is listening. I'm sorry for my potty mouth.
Did it again.
Yeah. Everyone's rushing back.
It did. Yeah, that happened to us too. It was like 40 seconds remaining and kicked everybody.
What is wrong with us?
Well, I thought that was a fun category.
I have a feeling that it's not giving them
number two. Yeah, hopefully you got number two.
No, that's the one. That's the only one our team couldn't.
Everyone's back. Okay,
that was fun. So nice.
That was fun. Category. Like good job, Mike.
I like to call it clever. People who have never been in my kitchen or people in this year trivia group.
Yay, Mike!
That's really good.
First one of those groups is smaller.
Trivia question from Cliff Clavin.
And I didn't know number one. I want you to know I've never seen
answer number one is
I almost Susan. Didn't know number nine actually too. That's just sad.
The original question for that was what were the first names of the characters played by Sherry Stringfield and Anthony Edwards on the TV show ER? But then Susan told us we could only have one answer per question. So Mark and Susan became just Susan.
Cool.
You is, of course, Poor Richard's Almanac. Richard Saunders was Benjamin Franklin's.
Yeah, see, you learned something today.
What
Richard.
A silly name. No one will believe a name like that.
Right, it's just amazing.
Number three, the other vampire slayer, played by Eliza Dukeshoe, who got her start in that Arnold Schwarzenegger movie, but was Faith, the vampire slayer.
Yay.
Number four, a lot of people seem to be having, this was, I think, maybe the hardest one, Steiner Studios.
Yes! No, we thought about that, but we were like, no.
We talked.
You really didn't.
Okay, that's kind of
sorry, Brian.
Based
Terry,
on having three.
That's awful. You're fired.
No, I
said five.
You didn't know yours either.
But I'm the popular right. singer Robert Palmer.
Yeah.
All right.
There you go.
Six. Good. The movie is Kelly's Hero, so we're looking for
Kelly.
The name Kelly.
Hey, Kelly.
Number seven, the animated character from the TV show King of the Hill, Peggy Hill.
Yes.
Yay.
That's my girl.
And that played by Kathy Najimy from Sister Act 1 and 2. The world's largest inland body of water, of course, the Caspian Sea.
How long did it take Susan to get that?
Well, I was reading it as
at least 20 seconds.
I saw the word America in there for some reason. So I was thinking Tahoe, Erie.
You skipped Tahoe. Number eight.
Somebody you know well.
Oh, the identity taken over by Jason Todd, then Tim Drake. Jason Todd was killed by the Joker, Tim Drake, and Stephanie Brown. There's a few others, but that was Robin, Batman's friend.
Yay.
And then number 10, Ingrid Bergman's younger famous daughter that was in the David Lynch movie, Isabella Rossellini.
Yay, Isabella.
Looking for the first name, so Isabella.
That was really fun.
Copy these up to the
So Mike, the question is, did you have a longer list and you tweaked it to make sure everyone was here?
I had I'm going to put in the one that I'm disappointed I was not able to use. What was the name of the actress who played Katarina on Doctor Who? She was the first companion character
to
be killed off on the series.
Was it
was a multiple choice question. It was either Jacqueline Hill, Adrienne Hill, Elizabeth Sladen, Jenna Coleman, or Jodie Whittaker. And of course, the answer.
She missed out. She went to that book club. She should have been here. That's really funny.
So, yes, we did as people
very good.
Popped in. We switch those around. So yes, this is everyone who was here.
That was fun.
That was a lot of fun.
Great category.
That was a great fun category.
Very,
I like it.
Very
and the extra effort of making sure it was people that were here is great.
Extra points.
Greatly appreciated.
Extra kudos.
Mike is extra points.
Plus, I'm super happy I did a category the same night you did that.
I gotta follow Kansas. That. Oh my
about
god.
Kansas.
And
with
fun.
That, I'm going to bed. Good night, everybody.
Good luck, Kelly.
Hey,
hero.
Kelly.
Kelly Savalas and Don Rickles for us.
All right.
Good night. Okay. I'm going to bed too.
Take care, Abby.
Oh,
good night, studio. Okay.
Night, Abby.
We need to get points. All right. So,
scores.
Where are we at?
Scores.
Everybody got 9 out of 10.
Scores.
Hold on. Goodness gracious. Calm yourselves down.
Goodness gracious. Great.
We could have had a 10 out of 10. Dang it. Oh, well.
All right. So, sixfold decrease in chicken for breakfast.
Nine. And we would have had 10 if we'd gone with Steiner.
If we would have listened to Brian and Terry. Oh, well.
That would have been luck.
Well, we're usually wrong, so that.
But that was such a great category. It would have been great to ace it.
So, you just said that you had breaks. 9 and you would have gotten 10 if you'd gotten the other one right.
That's right. And he was on our team.
So it was foretold we would win.
That was a real kicker.
I knew that was a hard one, but I thought, well, at least Avi will get that one.
Is it 10?
It is 10.
All right. So Washington versus Worcestershire.
9.
And the non-essential oils.
9.
9.
This way to the great aggressive, no regrets or frets for
10.
10. You didn't want me to say it? That's not right. Okay, here we go.
Don't come up with the long name if you don't let her say the whole name.
Yeah, seriously. I got to say the whole damn name.
I was just so excited about getting 10. I couldn't hold it in anymore.
Very good. So that was really good for it was foretold that we would win because they got 1 point more than a lot of the others. So, and you were almost in last place. So that helped you out a lot.
Thank God. We needed to redeem ourselves badly from the second round.
Yeah. First round.
We lost two players this time, right now.
Three.
Yep.
Three?
Yeah, we're on our way out.
I don't know about we. Oh, no. Oh, no, don't leave me by myself again. That.
Oh, no.
Oh, Deborah.
I don't have Isabella this time.
I'll help you out, Deborah. I don't know how much help I'll be, but I'll stick around.
Susan, I don't know how much longer I'm going to last. I feel like my body's like dying right now.
I'll be quick.
I'll give powers to somebody else.
I'm like, I can't even sit up. Like, I'm just, my body's giving out from the shot.
Who wants the power? You need a time enough? I'm not getting any volunteers.
Wait, did I miss that? Did Isabella get the vaccine?
Yeah, I got a vaccine yesterday.
Oh, I missed that. Oh,
Susan, yeah. One or two.
James,
I got one. I did have quite a busy day today, but I'm just like, I can't.
Drink a lot of water.
Yeah, I've been drinking water all day. I mean, I was like running around all day today because I had to take senior pictures, like cap and gown photos.
Oh.
And then if I realized that my gown was way too short and I had to borrow a friend's and it was a whole mess.
Oh.
Yeah, high angles, and you wouldn't have to worry about your shortness of your thing.
Yeah, I had to I have to contact the company, and the school's suggestion was ask a friend if you can borrow theirs. And I'm like, well, I paid $100 for it. So you should at least figure out a way for me to, anyways. Yeah.
$100. My son paid $500 and didn't even get his graduation.
Oh my gosh. It's horrible.
$500 to, and he was supposed to go to the big, huge ceremony. They canceled the whole thing.
Susan, you have a taker for the new Isabella.
Well, I already gave it to James.
Oh, I thought, okay. And not me. It wasn't me. I thought you missed the person.
Nobody was fast enough. I saw James' hand go up. I don't know if James wanted it, but I gave it to him.
Yeah.
Isabella, before you go, you are on next week.
Yeah.
And Caspian's on next week.
You sound so excited about it, Isabella.
No, I'm having a hard time sitting up.
I think she needs to go.
You better put her in.
What about Isabella?
Take care of yourself.
But the next one's murders.
Oh, wait, no, I'll stay for murders. I'll just do it from here.
Are you joking? Serial I think killers. She's joking.
The next one's serial killers. She's joking.
We don't know.
Okay, I'll see what it is. I'll decide. Maybe I'll stay for the questions, and then I'll bounce.
You'll know some of them.
Okay, I'll stay.
Oh,
I'll stay.
All right,
Kevin. I'll stay.
You guys ready?
Yeah.
The category is, I'm going to post it.
James has some news.
Abbreviations, acronyms, and extensions.
Oh.
What?
Right. Good night, Isabella.
Oh, you mean what?
First,
no, Kevin, it's great.
It's okay. I expect.
No, it's great. I was just making a joke. It's great.
She slowly sinks out of sight.
Kevin, you're muted. Okay.
I tried to unmute myself 5 times. Okay. The first question: what do the letters ZIP stand for in zip code? And then the next question. I'm going to do 2 at a time, make it quicker. What do the letters D and M stand for in CAD/CAM? Question 3, what does TMZ stand for? Question 4, what is the banking term FDIC? Question 5, what is the A in the word laser? Question 6. It's one that has 2 answers. I'll take either one. What does
ROTC or PDF? It says and, but I'll take or. Question 7, when a company advertises a part as OEM, what does OEM stand for? And the rest, we get a little bit trickier. Number 8, oops, it didn't work. Hold on a minute.
Can I ask a question about 6?
Yes.
Are those related in some way?
No, they're not related.
Okay.
I had a list of 4 there and I broke it down to the 2 obvious ones.
Okay, good.
So just either one. Number 8, what does the extension on a photo file JPG or JPEG, what does it stand for? Number 9, what does the computer acronym GW Basic stand for? And number 10, you have to have both of these. What do VHS and VCR stand for? And then just for fun, SCUBA, MASH, and DVD, which I eliminated off my list.
How are we doing? Anybody have questions? Good job on speed.
I have a question about number 10. Doesn't it ask for 2 answers?
Yes, it does. If you get one, you should be able to get the other.
One answer.
That's against the rules.
Okay, then one answer. If we're going to go there, get either one.
Can we do the same thing for number 6 since you're asking for 2?
Yeah.
Well, that was an or. So or is okay.
Yeah.
So 10, change it to or.
And is not okay. Okay, yeah. So that's just an or.
Yeah, just change both 6 and 10, change to or because we're one answer.
Oh, I have to go into a room.
Jane, do you want to hear the initials?
No, I figured out how to bring down the
chat. All right. First one is zone improvement plan. Second one is CAD and CAM, computer aided design and computer aided manufacturing.
Right.
Number 3, no clue. TMZ.
Oh, time zone. No.
That's that gossip site, right? The celebrity gossip site.
So I thought it was the North Korea, South Korea.
Well, that's the DMZ.
TMZ.
That's DMZ. TMZ is that popular website that's celebrity gossip. You can read about the Kardashians and all the people there.
But we don't know what it is.
I don't know what it is, but we can make a guess maybe from the, if you think about
enjoying this.
Gossip.
FDIC is Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation.
Wow. Right.
The A in laser is
amplification.
Yeah. 6, Reserve Officer Training Corps for portable document format.
Jeez. Right. Okay.
Number 7 is OEM is Original Equipment Manufacturer. Number 8, no clue, JPEG.
I've seen it, but I'm not sure what it is.
So James, is this like, did you get your vaccine?
Yeah. Monday. I'm still sore.
You only have one now?
Yes. One down.
Did that help you with these categories? Because you're jamming through these. I have no idea. So I thought maybe you're getting it directly from Bill Gates or something. Some mixture of the having COVID and also so it's too early to know if you're feeling better.
Yeah. I was able to walk a little bit more today. So
which shot did you get?
Pfizer.
Okay, so you got a ways to wait. So okay.
Yeah. Cool. I have to wait till
for number 8, it's JPG. I'm thinking P and G might be portable graphic.
I like that.
Makes sense.
But what does it mean?
I think it's something very strange, like joint professional group or something like that.
Could be some insider.
No idea.
professional group?
I'm sure I've heard it, but I don't know what it is.
I've seen it, but I
think it's joint professional group. I remember looking it up and I just remember thinking that I would never think that because those words just don't like, they don't really make that much sense together as a graphics format.
Yeah.
Well, it's not really describing the graphics format. It's describing the group that copyrighted it.
Okay.
It's actually a licensed format. While the GIF or GIF, whichever you prefer,
is graphical interface format, right?
Yeah, but that one's a public format that wasn't copyrighted. CompuServe people came up with that.
Remember that some years ago there was this one of these conspiracy theories about people pedophiles, and they one of the things they said was they were exchanging JPG files, and this conspiracy theory said that JPG, I forget what J was, but P and G stood for pretty girls. And you idiot, you don't know what the JPG is a standard format for videos. But
it stands for juvenile pretty girls.
Yeah, something like
that. So oh my God, but you know, I could see them believing that.
Oh yeah.
Easily. Okay, so what do we got, nine?
That's where, number nine is JW Basic.
I don't know this
one. GW Basic.
GW, and I can't remember who it is. GW is the company. Like there's an MS Basic for Microsoft Basic. GW Basic is the company.
George Washington.
That put it out, and I can't think of the company. I don't think it's George Washington.
Great Western?
I don't think it is.
Oh, Great Western. That's a good guess.
Oh, yeah, Great Western. Might
be, yes.
General. VCR, video cassette recorder, and I forgot. We only have to answer one, right?
Yeah. What would the other one be? Video.
Very high security. Very.
Video horse.
Very, very high standards.
It's, I don't know. It's a Latin word for not as good as beta.
But GW Basic, is Basic an acronym also?
Yeah. That went away years ago.
Acrylic.
But if it's part of the acronym, I assume we have to define that to go along with the GW.
Oh, right.
It's like one of those abbreviations that they came up to make it fit Basic. So it's Basic.
Yeah.
Did we come up with anything for TMZ?
Turner, could it be like Turner Broadcasting Network? Like that would be the site. It would be like Turner Major Zippers. I'm so horrible at these things, but it might be like the name of a brand.
I think the T is the. I think it's the something. I can't remember.
The hot the mess
zone.
The zone.
Could the M be media?
Ooh.
Oh, good one.
Media zone?
Media zone.
Yeah.
Makes some sense.
If that makes sense.
If you get two out of three right, will they get count?
The media zone. That's good. Yeah.
If we get two out of three, does that give us like a six-fold reduction in the point?
So which one are we missing, Basic?
We're missing TMZ. We're missing, now JPEG, we're going with Joint Professional Group. Was that it?
Yeah.
Okay. GW Basic, and that's it.
James, remind me what one is. That was really interesting.
Zone Improvement Plan.
Huh. That sounds like a very government inspired name.
Yeah.
Nashua's Mobile
Army Surgical Hospital.
Say it again.
Mobile Army Surgical Hospital.
Yeah.
And scuba?
Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus.
Well, go ahead and give me DVD.
Digital
video disc
or device. Digital disc, okay.
Wow. I have never paid attention to my acronyms. Okay, Basic would be
I would think stands for code.
B stands for code?
C.
Oh, yeah.
How about I for information? Information code?
Mm-hmm. And this might be standards.
Instruction code.
Instruction.
Okay, so B could be B for basic?
Binary?
Binary is good. Binary, alphanumeric, standard information code.
I'm fine with that. That sounds fancy.
Well, what does GW stand for? Oh, we said...
Great Western.
Oh, Gulf and Western? No, that's Gulf
Great,
and Western.
Great, movie Great Western.
Great Western.
Great Western.
Yeah. That was a company, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great Western.
Wow, this team rocks.
So B, A could be... What did you say? B's basic ones?
Which one?
Basic. GW basic. What is the basic part?
Binary... Alphanumeric was I heard.
Well, alphanumeric is one. Algorithmic is another, which sort of is computer. But
S.
Standard system? Information code.
No, standard information code.
Mm-hmm. I think alphanumeric probably makes more sense because they were probably didn't want to use the punctuation symbols as part of the language.
Uh-huh. So binary, alphanumeric, standard information code.
That's
let's go with that.
That's as good as I can come up with.
I can't think of anything better.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Being right,
very Western, basic or binary, alphanumeric, standard information code.
Yeah,
It's probably a lot simpler than that, but I can't think of anything that would make sense. That's good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ready? I'm calling everybody back.
Right.
Okay.
Why is it cutting short, Susan? You don't know.
I have no idea. Okay, I didn't notice it doing
Susan,
it.
Return now, Susan? Susan, can you return back?
Return back what?
Return back, leave the breakout room. Are you breaking the timer by leaving the breakout room early?
Oh, I don't know.
That's what I'm saying. Leave the breakout room now and let's see if we stay.
Susan, I'm gonna send you this thing on Facebook and you should read it to the group.
Why didn't you just read it?
Okay, I guess I'll read it.
But wait till everybody gets here.
So I don't know if you knew, but they opened up a Chick-fil-A in North Salinas. Yeah, so that's kind of what it's about.
Okay, you can say it when we get over
here. I will. And then my Tylenol's kicking in, so maybe I think I'll be able to stay. I'm feeling the effects.
Just feeling better.
I do like our group just like randomly started having a discussion without finishing the questions. That was pretty good. So
that'll be that
that's the way it is. That's the way we
that's
work.
That's a sign of a good, set.
Brian, does that ever religious. Not happen?
I think they're cheap.
Isabella's still here. Wow.
Yeah, he says there's Tylenol's
kicking in, so I'm feeling a bit better.
Yeah.
All right.
Hey, Aaron, did you guys end up staying after I left?
Yes.
Okay. Well, that answers that. I don't know why he did that, but he did. Isabella had something she wanted to say before we got back.
Okay, so recently in our town of Salinas, California, they opened up a Chick-fil-A. And so there's this Facebook group I follow. And this, it's kind of like stuff that happens in Salinas, because apparently that's like something a group is for. And so this is the story that this lady posted. So I was in the Chick-fil-A drive-thru and a lady behind me continuously tooted her horn and flipped me off because I was taking too long to order. Once she ordered, I asked the cashier what she got. It wasn't much, so I decided to pay for her food. I continued to the next window and she leaned out of her window looking all crazy at me because the cashier told her I'd paid for her food. I know she was embarrassed, so I avoided looking at her through the rear window so we wouldn't catch eye contact. When I got to the last window to get my food, I showed the assistant both my receipts and took her food too. I paid for it and it's mine. Now she has to go around again and wait longer. She
I'm glad she learned her lesson. Also, F the lady in the red convertible.
That, put this into effect.
That's an awesome story.
Yeah, I thought everyone would enjoy it.
You know, I wouldn't do something like that.
Yeah, I feel like that's too mean.
Not
that's
anybody, no way would I have
done that. That is something I would not do in Salinas. Or to put this into perspective,
I've seen that this line is more than a mile long for the drive-thru right
no,
now.
No, apparently it's taking people like over 2 hours. Like, I might as well drive to like San Jose.
Oh my God.
They opened one up here in Seattle and it is like, and I have never not seen it go around the block.
I agree. Karen says it's an urban legend. I bet you it is.
It is, because I've heard this story.
Are you aware that the owners of Chick-fil-A are very evangelical Christians?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
They aren't even yes. up on Sunday.
Everyone is, everyone is aware it. Of this.
That's why everybody booed when she mentioned the name. Yep.
They're actually, they don't want to pay overtime on Sunday. They hide behind religion.
They hide behind it because they are, in fact, religious.
Why would they pay overtime on Sunday?
They don't have to pay overtime on Sunday.
They don't open on Sunday.
They're not open on Sunday because they want their.
They wouldn't have to pay overtime on Sunday.
Yeah, I always thought that that was sort of, despite I disagree with them, but I thought that was like at least they have the conviction to close on Sunday.
Right.
Which does lose them money. But
they said, you know what they said? They said they make enough money Monday through Friday, Saturday, and they closed on Sunday.
But, well, one of the really interesting things was when the Atlanta Falcons built a new stadium, Chick-fil-A won the contract to supply food. They opened up Chick-fil-A's in the Falcons stadium.
Yeah,
football Sunday.
And the primary day that football plays is on Sundays.
Yeah.
And they did not, and they did not open for those games. They had and they weren't open. I didn't
know. The atheists on Sunday.
Exactly. They couldn't find a couple of atheists or
no, I don't think that's allowed
to do it. I mean.
Hmm. Oh, so I have something to share. This happened.
We could send Susan in there and have her cook in our chicken.
Yeah, send any heathen on the Sundays. Like, it's fine.
This happened last week, I think, between, I think it was between last week and this week. Leonard had that fantastic picture of a red-tailed hawk. And so now it's on Wikipedia.
Oh, nice.
That's cool.
I've seen that before.
Is it the blue one?
The hawk.
No, it was the close-up of the head.
Yeah, that's a beautiful picture.
Yeah, gorgeous.
Wikipedia. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Very good. I wonder who took care of that for you.
It was an elf.
An elf, a little helping elf.
Yeah. Okay, somebody who was in a band with Duran.
That was pretty. That was really fast. Our team knew him.
Everybody should get a 9 or 10 on this.
I didn't know any of them.
Famous last words.
Okay, so let's see what you got.
Okay.
Oh, big body of water that plays this game. Michigan, Erie. I don't know.
Tahoe.
I seriously thought it said America in the thing.
We'll just annex it.
No problem. We got this. I'll just put it in the backyard.
And then I get a house on it because it's mine.
We need the water, so for sure.
We don't want that water.
The Tahoe?
The Caspian.
Oh, no. We don't want those.
Okay, Kevin.
You guys ready for the answers?
Yeah.
Yep.
Number one, zone improvement plan.
Are you putting these in the chat, by the way?
Yep.
Okay, because I can't spell anything.
Number two is computer-aided drafting or design and manufacturing. So it's D, drafting, design, M, manufacturing. Three is 30-mile zone.
30-mile zone?
Yep.
Really? Wow.
Yep.
Way off base on that one.
We thought it was some gossip magazine or
something. It is. And it's a Hollywood thing.
They're named after that real thing.
Oh. Yeah, it's a real policy about what's considered local versus remote, like versus traveled work.
Oh. Yeah, so a student doesn't have to pay for overnight hotels if it's like 30 miles. That was the original thing that time.
Never heard of that. Okay.
Number four, Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation.
FDIC,
Number five, amplification.
Will you accept amplitude?
Amplification. Nope. Amplification. Number six is either Reserve Officers Training Corps or portable document for print, portable document format. Not printable document, portable document format.
What if we have both?
Well, you get point.
Yippee.
1 point.
1 point for either or both.
No.
You get one point. If you get
one point
right.
Either way.
Yeah.
Yep. OEM is an original equipment manufacturer. JPEG, Joint Photographic Experts Group.
Oh, man.
I had two of the letters right.
We really rock.
GW Basic, either GWiz or Graphics in Windows for the GW, and the Basic is Beginner's All-Purpose Symbolic Instruction Code.
It's also Bill Gates' initials, William Gates, as in Gates, W for William, or his co-author was, I forget his first name, was Witten. So it's GW.
Oh, so they did it on purpose?
It's unclear.
I was told it was GWiz, and then someone told me it's Graphics in Windows, and I looked it up and I found both answers online.
This one's not clear.
Could it be what we said, Jane? What did we say? Great Western or something?
Yeah, something like that.
No, if you said what I said or what Leonard said, it's okay. But other than that, I won't.
But Jane said it with such confidence.
I didn't know what it was.
And number 10, video home system and video cassette recorder. Need one of them.
Home system. Oh.
So on number two, it required two answers. Are we taking one of the two?
One of the two.
I think people should know that. It's CAD CAM is like considered almost like one thing now.
Yeah.
So you need the D and the M. Well,
yes, I think so. Okay. Yes, D and M. Because some people got it, and if some people didn't only got one, it wouldn't be fair to those who got the whole thing.
Oh, okay, got it.
Okay, so we're changing the rules again. That's fine. Good.
Well, I just want to go on the record that we're changing the rule.
Well, he could have written it slightly differently, which would have still been one answer, right? What? Because it's a term, CAD-CAM. What do the two letters mean that are, you know, not?
Specific? Yeah, I could have done a laser. The letters mean in laser? That would have been horrible. Yeah.
All right. Well,
light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation?
Right. That's right.
That's easy.
Right. But you
knew that one.
All right. Good job. Sixfold decrease in chicken for breakfast.
Five big ones.
Woohoo. Five big ones. It was foretold that we would win.
What's your ruling on number two?
You have to have drafting or design, one of those two, and manufacturing. So you have to have both parts, CAD and CAM.
It's been eight.
Okay.
Ooh.
So the Washington versus Worcestershire.
Seven.
Worcestershire.
I wish I was on your team.
Worcestershire. Okay, the non-essential oils.
Nine.
And this way to the great egress of no regrets or frets for snowy egrets.
Ten.
Oh.
I knew somebody would get them all.
That's kind of, well, we'll see what Gail has for us.
Deborah's giving you the information you need to say our group name.
Okay, 22, 30,
30,
33, and 36.
Yikes-a-loo.
So 22.
That's a surprisingly large spread.
Yeah, well, the biggest spread I can remember.
Now.
Yeah.
That was good, Kevin. Very good. So far, I'm enjoying all my categories, even though I'm not doing so well at answering them, but I feel like I'm getting somewhere.
Yeah, the chicken team got two really bad scores. That's what happened.
I know.
We did.
Chicken team.
Well, we only lost scores. People during the last round. So
coming soon, WTFIAOB.com.
Okay, Gail. Co-host Gail. Good job. Here we go. Bring it in for us. Bonus.
Bonus round.
Okay. The American Kennel Club recognizes and registers 195 different purebred breeds of dog. This is the list of the top 10 in popularity for last year.
Gail,
I have the list of the first 50 if you want to see them later.
Okay. Gail, they don't have to be in order, do they?
You muted yourself, Gail.
How is the popularity measured?
I'm trying to hit the...
If it's AKC, it's probably registered dogs.
These are all registered purebred dogs, yes.
So American Kennel Club.
This is the number of dogs that they registered. Here we go.
So the bougie dogs, not the pound dogs?
They're not mixed breed dogs of any kind or designer dogs where they're mixing two breeds. Mm-hmm. These are all purebred dogs, and they're based on the popularity based on registration.
I see.
Okay, so is this 2020? 2020.
And they don't have to be in order, do they?
They do not. You're just finding the 10 breeds out of the 195 possibilities.
I think it was a perfectly worded category.
Yeah. It was lovely.
What is this 2020 you're talking about? What's a 2020?
We never left 2020.
Yeah. When never did they happen?
Yeah, that isn't
the list just
nothing happened in 2020.
We skipped it.
Yeah, we went straight from 2019 to 2021.
Apparently, yeah. People bought dogs.
I personally think this is too objective. We should have something that, like, you know, top 10 dogs according to Siskel and Ebert or something.
Friendly.
You need your room, Rob. Okay, Gail, you've got powers now.
Oh, do I? Because it's asking me to go to the room. Okay.
Yeah, well, it will.
Golden Retriever.
Hello, team.
Hello, Susan.
I think Susan should have a special room set aside for people who
need to be sent to the room.
What's up, Susie Q?
Oh, somebody wants help. Gail, go to this way to the great egress. They want you. They're asking for me, but they want you. Hello, team. I know German Shepherd's in there.
Golden Retrievers and Bulldogs.
What kind of bulldog?
Like a French bulldog?
French or English?
They might both be in there.
Why can't we just put bulldogs?
Because there's more than one bulldog.
Good point.
There's at least the English and French.
How about a toy poodle?
I don't know if a toy poodle is going to make
it. I would just say poodle. And just
How about a poodle? Something that fits in your purse. That was kind of the dog.
A purse poodle?
No, I think your
dog that fits in a purse.
But Susan, as someone who every single Thanksgiving watches the dog show, I know my dog.
That gives you a perverse idea of the dogs that are out there.
Yeah, they have. I know they.
Susan, Kevin is stuck. He needs you to put him in a room. Oh. He's stuck. Oh,
he's been banished.
He was supposed to go. Oh, there he is. Okay. All right. I'll go over there and deal with Kevin.
So what about pugs? Can we put pugs on our list?
I think that's probably a sound. Gail?
I thought you needed Gail.
I need to go to my room. I ended in the wrong room. I couldn't switch.
Okay. So you're supposed to be in
the Washington Worcestershire's. I can't say it.
Yeah, yeah. See, you say that. Okay, move to Washington, Worcestershire. Okay, bye.
Can go by myself, or do I have to click?
You should buy
it, Corey. I think they're higher than pugs.
Oh, really? Those? They're very cute.
They are
cute, and they're in a lot of ads and shit. But they're not.
I mean, the Queen does have them.
Golden
Retrievers.
Oh yeah,
Golden
Retrievers
are already on the list. And Yellow Labs.
Just Labs. Labrador Retriever.
French Bulldogs.
Yeah.
I think you need to specify your retrievers.
Golden and Labrador.
I would agree with that.
Labrador Retriever, Golden Retriever.
A pug, a poodle, we might have to be more specific about poodle. Let's come back to that and argue about that.
What about a beagle?
six.
Actually, Isabella, I feel like I watched the dog show last year or this year, and there was a surprise at the top. Didn't something surprise people?
Yeah.
There was an upset.
A Borzoi.
But that
doesn't mean it's popular. It just means it won.
That's fair.
Well, it could mean that the next year everybody wanted it because that was what won.
No, because how many people?
I remember one year this really, really cute little French bulldog won, and then everyone wanted French bulldogs.
No, I absolutely think French bulldogs should be on the list specifically. Oh, yeah.
I think they should not exist, actually.
Why?
Well,
they're
that's
cute.
A fair shot, but...
No, they can only be born by the C-section of the female.
They can't even really breathe. They have to be artificially inseminated.
They're cute.
So why was Corgi ruled out?
We don't think it's popular enough.
But it was like after the crown and all that, everybody want it?
No, they don't.
Scratching your back.
Well, I think it's on the list.
Jack Russell Terrier should probably be on the list.
You think a Jack Russell?
You want to scratch it for me.
What about a German pointer?
No.
Yeah, a Dachshund. What about a Dachshund?
Yes. I think maybe the border collie Dachshund might be on the list.
I think Dachshund.
Dachshunds are very cute.
Dachshund.
No.
I don't like Dachshunds.
No, they're not cute.
Dachshunds? The little wiener dogs?
No. No. But I think I have the same problem.
It's not about what's cute. It's about what's popular.
I think
popular.
They're very popular.
I think
agree.
Cats
I don't
are
like
popular.
Either,
I have the same problem.
Susan, I don't like cats.
I have the same problem with dogs.
Don't kick her out, Susan. Just kick her out now.
No. Who has to come and see Hamilton, she said.
That's yeah, because Hamilton has character. Hamilton, I want to feed
I was
Hamilton
tell you,
jello.
Isabella, when you come over to meet Hamilton, you have to bring treats because he's super skittish of people. You're gonna have to come very
and don't bring anything that he can piss on.
Okay.
He hasn't pissed on anything since he pissed on you years ago.
Yes, on my clothes, yes. I remember Susan.
He went right up to her suitcase was right there and he went up to it.
Yeah, oh he just God. He faced away from it, and I heard a sound, and I'm like, are you kidding? He's doing it. He doesn't even look. He's just perfectly aimed at all my clothes. Thank you.
He never did that. He hasn't done it since, and that was years ago.
Class, we must get back to the subject at hand.
No Dachshunds.
What about
I'm not saying they should be on the list.
There's a lot of people I know that are
I like Malamute Huskies, but I don't think they'll make this
what
list.
Is that
or with the blue eyes
no the Huskies the Malamutes are like a fluffier slightly dumber husky.
It's so funny to see.
How dare you?
Hey, you guys, what
Paula's
about Chihuahua? Chihuahua should be on the list.
Ugh. Oh.
Paula is popular. From,
yes.
What about
from
a German
face
shepherd?
Of a cat.
What about a German
dog.
Shepherd?
We have German
I'm
shepherds.
Not a cat.
Okay.
For the I'm record, not I'm not saying Dachshunds shouldn't be on the list. I'm just saying I have the same objection to them that Paula does to French Bulldogs.
Oh, they've been overbred that they're like.
But a lot of people super into Dachshunds.
I have a friend that has like six.
And super into Corgis.
Dachshunds?
Is your friend that has six a weirdo?
Is this like the Wienermobile thing?
Well, the mom, so my friend, her mom's boyfriend, like, oh, ex-husband, like, stole three of them when they got her divorce.
Can I just get a word in here? Cocker Spaniel is probably on the list.
Probably. Some kind of spaniel.
I'm putting Cocker Spaniel on the list.
How about anything?
No one can stop you.
That'll fit in a purse will work. So
Susan, that's like really like 2000s ish. That's not 2020.
The Kardashians gonna have a purse in a dog in every.
I don't even think the Kardashians have pets.
Kick her out for mentioning the Kardashians.
I think they have like Fitch. That's it. They don't make any mess.
You won't kick her out for hate cats. You're not kicking her out. Okay, here's a list, a tentative list.
We have a list.
Labrador Retriever, Pug, Poodle, German Shepherd, Golden Retriever, French Bulldog, Jack Russell Terrier, Chihuahua, Cocker Spaniel, Beagle.
I don't think Chihuahuas are on the list.
Chihuahuas are
yeah.
Oh no, Chihuahuas
really need dogs.
Oh really?
Chihuahuas.
Oh, what was the one that was stole by Lady Gaga? They said there's a super popular.
It was a bull. She had two little blonde French bulldogs.
Was that what it was?
Yeah, French bulldog on the list.
They said that was super popular. The dog, super popular breed right now.
We need dachshunds on there.
I would agree with putting dachshunds on there. They're very popular.
Instead of which other thing on, instead of Cocker Spaniels, Beagles, what?
Would take off maybe the Terrier.
I would take Jack Russell off.
What? There's no herd dog on there.
And there's a reason for that.
I'm not sure they're big in America.
They're a pain in the ass. I have one, a Corgi herding dog.
Don't tell me, I have an Aussie.
Yeah. Well, Aussies might be on the list, actually. That's a good
one. Well, Peggy, will it fit in your purse?
Susan, no one has a
very large purse.
Nobody does that. Susan, I'm going to get you a little dog that'll fit in a purse.
Besides, we have Chihuahua, and they will fit in purses.
I have an armadillo. What? I do not need
an armadillo. Yeah. Yeah.
Armadillos are cute.
They are.
Look how adorable. Look at those big eyes.
They're not canines. I'm pretty sure they're not canines.
Real armadillos are cuter than that thing. That looks like a troll armadillo.
Isabella, are you okay?
Susan.
Look at him shake. He's so nervous. He's scared. He needs some bacon.
Stop.
That doesn't look Isabella like an armadillo. Like,
suffocate.
Do you think collies would be on that list?
Why no.
You know, they would have been years ago. So I just don't think they are now.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
In the 50s, they might have been.
What is a shepherd I'm trying to think of?
Why do you love
the Australian shepherd?
Where are my cats?
Well, I don't think a border collie would be on the list, although they're popular, but they're not top 10 popular.
I think border collies are top 10 popular.
I'm not sure they're... Our border collie is what I was trying to think of.
That's Mark's favorite dog, and we see him everywhere.
Why don't you have one?
Because I got cats.
Do you have Hamilton, the big personality?
We have a border collie at the end of the block, and Mark takes it for a walk.
Oh, seriously? That's cute.
And he takes pictures of it.
All the time. Oh. You'll see his Facebook feed.
It's a really pretty dog.
She is high. And the family just bought a Tesla.
Tessa
in her Tesla.
I can never see another Tesla without thinking of Tessa.
Yeah.
We need to get her raised to the rank of Contessa.
Contessa? Tessa. In her Tesla.
Can we go through the list one more time?
Yeah.
Only if you've got border collie on there.
No.
I don't think border collie.
I got to go let Gail in.
They're too hard. Okay. We have Labrador Retriever, Pug, Poodle, German Shepherd, Golden Retriever, French Bulldog, Chihuahua, Cocker Spaniel, Beagle, Dachshund. That's 10.
Okay, that sounds like a good list to me.
Questionable.
Thank you. I'm sorry about that. You're muted.
How did you get locked out?
I hit the button to leave meeting instead of to go to the other
room. Yeah. They shouldn't be so close together.
Well, they never were before, I don't think. I never had that problem before.
Okay. So I think we're almost ready. We're all just arguing. Do you have your special power still? Let me see. No, okay, now you do. Wait, now you do.
Okay.
Let me see. It looks like they're coming back. Let me go over to my room and see if they need anything.
Probably be a Staffordshire.
It's a separate list, yeah. But you just think about what's left over at the shelter. You've got Chihuahuas, Pit Bulls. Some years you have a lot of, like, Huskies. From the Balto movie, and then you've got Dalmatians from the Dalmatian movie. But this year, none of those are on there.
Well, the thing is,
other than Chihuahuas.
I thought there wasn't actually a purebred pit bull.
There's not.
Right. Okay, good. I'm glad to have that.
It can't be on this list, but that's
no, what, I mean, there isn't actually a breed.
Susan, I'm going to get you a West Highland White Terrier for Christmas.
Oh.
She's not, because it'll cost her $5,000.
What would I do? I travel a lot.
I don't know.
Put it this way. Caspian and Jamie will be watching it.
Or you can say you own a West Island
Isabella,
white
it'll just stay at your house. You could just babysit it for me.
Okay, I'll name it for you.
You could just babysit it. Okay, what's on our list?
We've got Labrador Retriever, Pugs, Poodles, German Shepherd, Golden Retriever, French Bulldog, Chihuahua, Cocker Spaniel, Beagle, and Dachshund.
Yes. So no Border Collie.
No Border Collie.
No, I don't think it's top 10.
Top Same 15, as your maybe. Little armadillo.
Well, we will see, won't we?
We will see.
Susan, I want to know the background story of your little armadillo. Where did it come from?
It's a sorted tale. I can't tell it on video.
She has a lot of stuffed animals.
Oh, she does?
No, not really.
Well, like 10 or 12 in that office alone.
Oh, seriously?
Well, I get when I travel, sometimes people give them to me. Like if I'm a speaker somewhere, they give me, I have a Tasmanian devil. Tasmanian tiger. I have a Tasmanian tiger. I got.
They make stuffed animals of those?
Well, I've got a kangaroo right there when I was in Canberra. And there's
you have a gorilla. I know you have a little gorilla.
I have my gorillas right there. Paula gave me my gorilla. He's right up there. Paula and Paulina. Oh, crazy. There he is.
Oh, yeah. That's cool.
And there's Pegasus. And there's a couple viruses over there. I think it's a Zika virus.
Oh, that's cute.
We'll see when you guys come over. Hurry up and get yourselves vaccinated so we can have a party.
Yeah, I get my next shot April 29th.
Susan, what date is a Skeptic Camp?
Oh, for Calgary?
January.
Oh, yeah. When was it?
No, when will it be? I might be going to Hawaii in January.
And I want to see Saturday of the year.
The first Saturday of January?
Yeah, the first Saturday. You're going to go to Hawaii?
Isabella, did you
I was supposed Moderna? To go to Hawaii last May, and it was kind of canceled.
I got Pfizer.
It'll probably be the 8th this year.
I got Pfizer.
Oh, Pfizer. That's probably what I had.
Yeah, and then I get the next shot April 29th.
21 days.
Caspian and Jamie, are you
And then Susan and I, and then I can game? Go meet Hamilton at Susan's house.
I have Moderna, right? I have to wait till May 1st for my second shot.
I'm talking to Jamie. Jamie.
At some point.
Well, I wanted to have you guys come. I'm dying to play the game.
Susan, you look so
sad. Might be a bad choice of words.
I want to play dominoes with people again.
Come on.
I like playing
dominoes.
I love dominoes.
Come and play.
Come and play with us, Jamie.
Susan, are you missing social interaction?
Oh my God. Well, that's what they're for. You know, they like to play games.
Well, you see, you start out talking to the cats, and then eventually you think the cats are talking to you.
Well, they do all the time.
Susan, I do have to say this. My mom loves your videos when you talk to Hamilton and post them on Facebook. She thinks they're very entertaining.
It's funny, these things that we do. We are so strange, aren't we? All right, so let's leave and go and let me make it this breakout room.
I'm not sure that's that unusual with cat people.
I think it's a cat person thing.
So yeah, Jamie, Caspian, when are you coming over? They left the room.
Susan, I'm so sorry.
Want and are gonna get with
them. Susan, maybe they don't want to come over.
I think they don't want to come over. Fine.
I'll come over. I'll play with Hamilton.
Isabella will come over.
Yeah. We'll have fun.
There's my white Cocker Spaniel.
Oh, that's so cute.
Oh, look at
that. That is my little brother.
And I thought you were on the right.
No, that's my little brother. And he is like...
You're on the left?
No. I'm the big monster on the right.
With the shot eyes.
That photo is from 1972, I believe. That dog lived to almost 20 years old. It was like 19.
Wow.
Yeah, she was born.
Was it named Cocker Mocker?
I was born.
Cocker Mocker.
Yep, yep. Her name was Sugar.
Sugar Mocker.
Yep.
It's almost as bad.
Cocker Mocker.
Susan, don't say that.
Is that a stripper name?
Yeah.
It's pretty funny.
Sugar cocker.
They learn in our group about the term cocker mom.
Okay, I'm ready for the took a cat in to a vet once, and the young woman behind the counter kind of gushing all over the cat. Oh, what a nice cat. What's his name? I said, it's an animal. It doesn't have a name.
Oh, oh. No.
And Lou is a cyborg.
I don't know. I don't think
not usually that human. Okay.
Gosh.
Okay, are you ready for the answers?
I am.
Yes, we are.
Okay, I will read the top 10 list, and then I will post it on the chat. And then if you have a breed that isn't on the top 10 list, I'm hoping it'll make the first 43, because I only copied the list down to 43. I'm assuming that the breeds that were lower than that you didn't think were in the top 10. But I'll tell you where the breed that you picked that wasn't there was if you
okay. Know.
Gail, did you get numbers of animals also?
No, just the order.
I'm just curious to how many there were.
Yeah, I they did not provide that on the website. So oh. I don't know the answer to that.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
Here they are. And I will read them in order, but you do not have to have them in order.
Okay.
The number one breed for the last 30 years, by the way, Labrador Retrievers.
Yay.
Labrador.
The surprising number two, because it has moved up rapidly, French Bulldogs.
All right.
Yeah, that we knew that one. That's what the Gaga's got.
The French Bulldogs.
They shouldn't exist.
That might be true, but they do.
They're very popular.
I like to call them freedom bulldogs.
What was number two? I'm sorry.
French bulldog.
Number three, German shepherds.
I told you. Yep, yep.
Or German shepherd dogs, as they would say.
Officially, the name is
like Aussies or something like that.
Number four, golden retrievers. Number five, bulldogs. Bulldogs are, many people call them English bulldogs. That's not the official name, but they are not the same breed as French bulldogs. Number six, poodles.
Okay. Yep.
Number seven, beagles.
Okay.
What?
Number eight, Rottweilers.
Ooh.
What?
Oh, Rottweilers. No, dang it.
Wow.
That's weird.
Number nine, and I suspect you didn't get this one, German short-haired pointers.
Damn it!
Oh.
Somebody
should have said it.
Sorry, team.
Oh, very not German long-haired pointers?
Yeah, very popular with white supremacists. I don't know.
Very popular for hunting.
Very popular.
Ah, yes, that makes
very good hunting dog.
That's what I said.
The last one on the list, dachshunds.
Oh,
yay. Okay. We're on the list, not the top 10.
What was number seven?
Number seven was beagles.
I still didn't hear you.
Beagles.
Oh, beagles. Okay. We got that one.
Or if you're in
and
New York.
And that's why I said varieties count, because there are two varieties of beagles based on size, but they're all beagles.
Mm-hmm.
There we go.
Here's the list.
Oh man, is there a website?
If you have a breed that you're just curious about, I'm not gonna post this whole big long list, but if you wanna know what it is, I'll tell you.
Do you have the URL for the website?
AKC.com.
Or no,
Mark, it's just the AKC.org.
Okay.
AKC.org.
What about corgis?
Corgis. Number 11, Pembroke.
Oh, so close.
What about Cocker Spaniel?
Cocker Spaniels used to be way up high, but they're way down now. Let me
find. Huskies
and
Ormeleys. That's
what we figured.
Cocker Spaniels.
Number 30.
Mm-hmm.
And Border Collie?
32.
Wow.
And how about Chihuahua?
Cocker Spaniels are number 30.
Oh, Chihuahua wasn't on the list.
Border Collies are 32.
We're just listing all of them now.
Chihuahuas are 34.
Chihuahuas are 34?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, why don't you just
Why don't you just
do it by weight, not by size?
I heard one group talking about Newfoundlands. They're 41. How about an armadillo?
The king
about a monitor lizard.
Susan, I love your armadillo.
There's your Dachshund.
Don't you guys in my group, King Charles Spaniel was 17.
Is the Dalmatian number 101?
Dalmatians didn't even make it onto this list.
Oh, wow.
Good.
I want to know why number 3 has the word dogs on the end of it when they're all dogs.
I've wondered that a lot.
The name of the breed. Hot dog, you mean like a wiener dog?
No, no, bonus question.
The official name of the breed is German Shepherd.
Oh, dog. Boy.
Bonus
maybe
question.
Because a German Shepherd is a person.
Germans like to be very verbose.
Well,
in their name. So you mean like a German who is shepherding in Germany?
They posted the link to the chat.
Which of these dogs go to heaven?
Yeah.
All dogs
go to heaven.
Just heaven? Just there. I don't know. I'm pretty sure I know some dogs that go to hell, but whatever.
Just because you may not be interested, I knew
all dogs go to Kevin.
I was interested in this and knew this.
They enjoy
the
anagrams.
For many years,
enjoy the dogs.
For many years, we bred and showed dogs. I was also still am licensed as a dog show judge. Dogs that don't appear on this list because we had Great Pyrenees and Brussels Griffons.
Poodle, that's good.
What's that, Caspian? What is that, Caspian?
It's a poodle.
Oh,
I really like this about trivia. I learned so much about you guys too.
Also,
things that you guys like and the things that you know and the things you're good at. And you're.
I love the Great Pyrenees. That's just a wonderful breed.
What about Huskies? Where are they at on the list?
Pyrenees are number 70.
Oh wow. We've been having some goats recently in Fort Ord that come and they bring them in every year to clear the brush, and they're guarded by Great Pyrenees, and these dogs are just like standing there going.
Yeah. The Great Pyrenees Club of America every year gives an award for the Pyrenees who has done the most dramatic selfless thing. The last one I remember was the person was being attacked by a snake and the dog jumped on it and killed it.
Oh wow.
And that's what they're guardian protection dogs.
The person.
And for all
I have
you
to
don't
wait
understand
up
the
it's
value
of 1 a.m. on the East Coast. 1 a.m. It's past my bedtime. So
we need to get a point. Okay, wait, let's get a point.
Gotta get the points.
Oh right, points. Sorry.
Okay. Six full decrease in chicken for breakfast.
Six.
Then let's go with Washington versus Worcestershire.
Seven.
It was foretold we would win.
Seven.
Well, that was a wash right there. The non-essential oils.
The wash?
Yeah.
Six.
X, ooh.
What was that?
And this way to the great egress of no regrets or frets for snowy egrets.
One.
What?
Six.
One.
Six.
Guys, you're funny. All right, so there's a share screen button in here somewhere. Dun, 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 dun.
Well, I know we're last, but
one hit 40. I'm really impressed.
Yay. Wow.
And our score is the answer to life, the universe, and everything.
Yeah, perfect.
Oh, yes.
So that's Carl, Leonard, Mike, Rob, Robin, and Karen. Good job,
yay,
you guys.
Good job, guys.
Nice work. Yeah.
Good night. I was even going to say German short hair pointer, but I thought I was too biased because between my dad and his brother, they've had eight different short hair.